Yeah, that's right. I heard that. What's up, guys?
Has anybody
Welcome
else actually
to the live stream.
watched a live stream like after we've done it? Have any of you
Yes.
guys like watched yourselves and listened to yourselves talk afterwards?
I know, I sound like a
Nope.
complete imbecile.
I've listened to one of some of my drunk ones and they're not
Oh.
that.
Dude, I was drunk on every single one, and I like the very first one that we did, I was like, oh, I'm gonna listen to myself talk. That's gonna be so cool. And then I freaking did it, and I was like, no way. I fucking cannot stand watching myself. I'm like picking apart everything I say, and I'm like, God, there's no way I can do this. It's too fucked up.
I'm the same way, man. You start going back through all of your thoughts, like what you were thinking while you were saying that, and it makes you insane. Plus, I sat there and went, golly, man, who is that bald southern hick motherfucker talking like that? I don't think I talk like that, but apparently I do.
You gotta just go with the flow.
Gotta go with it.
I already know I sound like a dumbass when I talk, so I just deal with it. I've already seen myself in videos and know I know I'm a stutter and I fucking mix words around and I do that shit all the time.
I know. I do that too. I fucking
You can't
mix
evade
words all
it.
the time.
Or I can't.
At least in the videos, I can like partially edit most of that out, so you don't get me just going just
Oh,
fucking
yeah. There's a
normal.
lot of this shit edited out on my videos.
I'm a freak about editing that. I will go down and edit out 0.2 seconds to edit out an
Yeah, I do that
Get out
too.
of there!
You don't realize how much you say that shit too, like actually going through the video. Cause most all my vlogs are just like off the cuff, fucking. You know, I don't like go out with a plan like, oh, I'm gonna talk about this and well, sometimes, but it's I don't know, it's kind of rare.
No, dude, most of the time I'm fucking drunk anyway, so sometimes I say like and fucking a thousand fucking times.
Balling. I know, I need to cut back on the fucks. I'm just a dirty sailor.
That's my thing. I went into this not swearing hardly at all, and then in my one that I posted this morning, I like say drop an F-bomb and tell a very off-color joke. I think the motovlogging world is being a negative influence on me.
Oh, whatever, motherfucker. I want to hear some stories on the road, all
Real
right?
talk. Yeah,
Some
let's
guy
hear
like,
some.
oh, I'm a musician who travels on the road like you don't know some fucking fucked up shit.
Ooh.
I've
I
never realized
do.
how much of a shitty mouth I got until I went to like Oregon to go visit my dad, and he lives in like the eastern Oregon where it's just, you know, towns and shit, and everyone's just well-mannered and talks normal and no one cusses, and I'm like, God, I gotta take it easy on what I'm saying.
Go ahead and fucking tone it back.
Yeah. I remember once me and my dad went to this like little like you know those bars, but bars that people can go into like under 21. It was one of those kind of things, and like remember them telling me how's the steak, and I was like, this shit's fucking good. And she kind of looked at me weird, and my dad's like, hey, you gotta go ahead and take it easy on talking like that out here, because these and it's true. I mean, out here in Cali, I guess it's just how you learn to talk, because you're around everybody talking like shit all the fucking time out here.
All right, guy. Chameleonaire asks us all a question. He wants to know how long we've been riding.
Chameleonaire?
Chameleonaire.
Oh,
That's a fucking
Riding dirty.
ass name. What's up, Chameleonaire?
Like the rapper.
You heard that before,
That's a karma chameleonaire.
They see me rolling. All right, go ahead, Derek. We'll go down the line. I'll go
Okay.
last.
Me?
Yeah, how long you been riding?
Oh, shit. Since before your grandma grew her first pube. I don't know, man.
Say 4 years with a
Back
pube.
when they had fucking steam-powered bikes.
Oh, no.
Light the boiler.
Since I was a teenager, so. And I'm 25, so I guess you do the math. Like 10 years, maybe? I don't know. But I
Fucking
ride
nerd.
every day, so I don't know.
Well, what was the very first bike you rode?
A 125 dirt bike. A TTR.
Little fucking nerd bike.
Yeah. But that wasn't a street legal bike, it was just a dirt bike.
Just fucking bombing around.
Pretty much a pit bike with bigger wheels, I guess you could say.
Yeah. All right, Josh, what was your what how long you been riding, and we'll just go ahead and say what was your first bike you rode.
Wait, are you guys talking to me? You guys were breaking up.
Yeah. Dirt bike. Or no, what was it? What was, how long have you been riding, and what was the first bike you rode?
14 years. And my first bike, I never rode a dirt bike. When I was 17 years old, I bought a GSXR 750 from a crackhead, $400. It didn't have a title or a tag or anything. And nobody gives a fuck in Tampa, so I rode that shit around, like, everywhere. Wrecked the fuck out of it, almost killed myself.
Nice. Go ahead, Tim.
All right, I'm almost afraid to say when I started riding, because it will definitely date my age, but I think everybody already knows I'm in my 40s anyway. I started riding in the summer of 1978.
Woo! Nice. Yeah. 5 years before I was born.
Yeah. I was just a little fart, but my first bike, which I still have the frame to the bike of that first bike, was a Montgomery Ward 1.5 horsepower Briggs and Stratton powered mini bike, and I've had motorcycles consistently ever since then.
Like a doodle bug? Is that the one that looks like a fucking doodle bug?
It's a little, it's a little twin spar frame. You know, it's got the twin spar frame and no suspension.
Yeah,
yeah.
Dude, you old as fuck.
Ballin'.
That's fucking awesome.
I started riding in 2004, I think, and I just straight up, I just went and bought an SV650S, and I was like, this is my first bike. Made my friend drive me to a church parking lot and, like, teach me how to ride it, and then I just, that's it. The end of story.
That year? Another like, fucking 2000. When you first rode your bike.
2004. When I first rode my
bike, it was insane. Like, I bought it from this crackhead from a trailer park for $400. And I was, like, talking to him outside, and he was like, oh, yeah, this on the bike, this on the bike. Everything on it was broken, but it still ran. And I'm, like, waiting for him to go back inside because I'd never ridden a motorcycle before.
Nice.
And I'm just like, well, yeah, so cool. And I'm sort of fucking, like, hanging out, like, yeah, you know, what's up? You know, and so he's sort of like, oh, all right, I'll see you. And he goes back inside, and I waited for a while, and, like, I pushed it down the street because I had to learn how to ride a motorcycle to ride it back to my house.
That's awesome.
Some buddies of mine own a motorcycle dealership, and one day this guy came in and bought a brand new, I think it was a Connie back when they were a 1200, and he had never ridden in his life, and he made it out onto the street in front of the dealership and crashed it.
Oh my God, man. Oh. I gotta imagine there's so many stories like that.
There goes that. My buddy bought a Triumph Tiger. And the day he got it, this is back when I had my 1000RR, we were going on, like, a big group ride, so we all met up, and we're leaving the very first corner, like, out of the parking lot. He just goes in, freaking too hot, flies off into a field, and just fucking lays that bitch out, like, compound fractured his toe, like, literally.
Oh, shit. Like,
the day he got it. Just see you later. And I'm like, dude, I hope you got insurance. He's like, oh, I got full coverage just to buy it, and then I called back and canceled it. I was like, oh, my God, paid like $9,000 for the fucker.
Oh, man, nothing like making payments on a motorcycle you can't ride.
Yeah, dude, crazy. He dropped that same bike another time in front of me, too. We were out by the lake going through some twisties, and he just, like, got all in the corner too hot and drifted out towards the side, hit the gravel, and he just fucking jumped off it. He's like, 6'7", this big fucking lanky fucking dude. So fucking Norm. Oh,
rolling off like a spider. Like,
yeah. he just like jumped up like a fucking flying monkey, and just the bike just goes skidding on out from underneath him. Like, oh my God.
Man, I have a million war stories like that. This one guy that we used to ride with, his name was Lynn. And when I was in my late 20s, early 30s, he was already in his 60s, and he was a crazy rider, and he liked to ride those late 70s, early 80s UJM bikes, like Kawasaki KZs and, you know, XS11s and all that. He was on this old KZ750, and we were out at this biker bar in Goldsmith, Texas called the Buckhorn, and he thought he'd do a little show out for everybody in front of the bar, and he went by and grabbed this little wheelie And he was wearing one of those gay Rob Halford biker caps that are made out of leather, you know, like Marlon Brando. And as the front of that bike started to come up off of the ground, he started to lose his hat, and he didn't want to lose his hat, so he reached back to grab it. and he missed the hat, but as the bike came back down, the forks were cocked, and he was doing 70 by that time, and he went down like a $3 whore on Saturday night.
Just fucking slapped on
the word. He slapped it. He went down to the caliche on the gravel part of the road. The bike turned around backwards, and he had no baffles in the tailpipe, so it was packed full of dirt. We had to dig dirt out of that muffler for like 20 minutes just to get the bike to start. It was redonkulous.
Oh my god. Crazy fucking... That sounds ridiculous.
Dude, there's an app called the Sound Nation Studio. I was looking at the apps, and it's one we can all make music together in the Hangout Live. Like, what? Through each other's dashboard. That shit's sick. I'm on it right now.
Add apps?
Yeah, go to add apps and click Sound Nation Studio. I wonder if you guys are seeing what I'm seeing right now.
I think I have to install it first, and then I should be able to.
I'm not seeing anything.
I just clicked, and I didn't even really install anything.
Let me see. I don't know shit about making music, though, so.
I do.
Me neither, but I'll try.
Oh, it's just like a collection of loops and shit. It's not.
Damn, okay. Get all
it does say MIDI right here, and I have a MIDI keyboard next to me.
Dude, get Buck on that. Get some 808.
Ooh, yeah. Easy there. Easy. Just some fucking straight old, like, shitty-ass fucking sounds.
Uh-huh.
Every time I try and click it, it just, like, opens and closes. Needs your permission to start.
Whoa, easy. I don't even know how to stop this shit. All right, there we go.
Here at Nomicon, we produce the finest crap you don't need. Leaders in the industry.
Yeah, it should just closed out for me.
I thought it would be cool.
Yeah, I just want to run on my Mac.
Hangout Toolbox. Oh, that's a Hangout extension. There's a bunch of little shit in here. Anybody else asking questions? Let me see.
What's in the toolbox?
All right, so I will say out of this, I feel like, Derek, that you have, like, the most quotable things on your channel, and it's kind of badass.
No. It's stuck in my head all the time.
In real life, when I'm throwing people out of the bar, and when some motherfucker gets, like, ape shit and fucking, like, freaking out and going, like, getting sweaty red face and being all angry, and I'm just like, hey, buddy, why don't we take it easy?
Yeah.
Easy.
Like, dude, it works like a motherfucker.
You just need to yell it, like, loud as fuck. Just go ahead and take it easy, and that just freaking smash them out.
That's why I made the shirt that says, go ahead and take it easy, really kidding on the front. So if anyone's getting some lip, you just point to the shirt.
You just point to the shirt. Just point to them and then point to the shirt.
That is funny, man. Yeah, your stuff, you are the master of sound bites, because I do that too. Because
dude, I told you, you need to make an app for phones, a soundboard, where you can just hit it and it just drops.
Baker X Derek soundboard, that would be good.
I could just record them all on my Yeti, all the sounds.
Yeah, dude, I told you, record all the sounds and send them to me. And
I'm
going to
close my thing and come back, just because my shit is like so lagging. So I think there's something wrong with my shit.
All right. It's all that porn you're downloading.
Mm-hmm. Don't be downloading torrents from Digital Playground.
Yeah.
So he's going to dump out and come back in. He just got a bad connection or something.
It's that Mac. That Mac can't handle all that power.
Mine actually, this one that I'm on right now, it struggles a little bit with Google for some reason. I think it's the browser. This browser's kind of old.
Got to install those updates. Keep that shit fresh.
Uh-huh. What is Kaku, Derek?
I don't know. I'm just experimenting.
Ah. Going through all the apps.
It said it's a drawing thing.
Oh, is it a a better drawing thing?
No, it's like I don't know if that's to do with drawing on your guys' video feeds, but it's like it looked like some blueprint looking shit. Someone's living.
Bill Gates all in here. There it is, living Rob. What's up?
Hey guys, how's it going?
Hey,
Was your head shaved last time, or did you just have a hat on so we didn't know?
I had a hat on.
Right on with the baldness.
Yeah, you and Tim, curl cones.
Yeah. We were talking about our first mini bikes and stuff, and I got pictures. Right? Come on, start screen share.
There it is. Oh, it is like a doodle bug.
I made a little mini photo adventure thing on one of those bikes on my channel. I don't know how to get rid of it.
That's it when I dug it out of the dirt after it had been buried in my dad's backyard for about 20 years.
Dude, that thing's got like little fucking clown wheels on it.
They're wheelbarrow wheels.
Yeah.
No brakes.
Oh, God.
My dumbass tried wheeling one of those and I just flipped it and like sprained my fucking fingers and shit. It was funny.
Yeah, my brother crashed his ass on this. He was always, my little brother, when we were little kids, he was always on me to let him ride that bike, man. And finally I said, you want to ride it? Go ahead and ride it. He ran it right into a cyclone fence. He didn't want any part of it after that.
What up, Joshua?
Is that Living Rob?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, fuck yeah, man. And he's outside. What's up?
What's up, man?
That's fucking awesome that you're outside. Did your wife kick you outside because you don't want no nerdy ass fucking motorbike?
Kinda. Nah, she's not home. It's nice outside.
Yeah, you have to do it when she's not home, right?
Yeah.
That is cool, though.
My girlfriend's in the living room watching Orange Is the New Black and drinking wine. She's way cooler than I am right now.
Yeah.
Classy as fuck.
Nice.
Orange Is the New Black.
Isn't that like some lesbians or something in jail? Is that what that show's about?
I don't even care. It's about fucking lesbians. Lesbians don't do it for me. So I'm like, fucking pause that shit. Go to the sit-go. Get me some beer. What's up? I'm almost out.
Let me just interrupt your show right quick.
Make-believe lesbians.
2014, you can pause that shit.
Just about a bunch of women in prison eating each other's sugar walls to death.
Okay. Yeah, you don't want the real lesbian. You don't want to observe that action. You want the made-up lipstick, super hot, ridiculous lesbians. That's what you want, that aren't even real lesbians.
Yeah. And Orange Is the New Black, I think they even have like a tranny on the show that's supposed to be like one of the women on there. And he was on Jimmy Kimmel Live, and I was tripping balls on that because everybody was wanting a piece of it in the comment section before realizing it was a tranny.
Derek wanted a piece of it, and then he realized that he still wanted a piece.
Yeah. Then I realized how a mushroom tip got in a woman's prison.
Oh, Mason Lovelace wants to know about your rape encounter, BXD.
My rape encounter?
That's what he said, almost rape encounter.
Dan Motovlogs, what's up?
Oh, Dan's here. Woo-woo!
Did I come in at the wrong time? You guys are talking about, like, rape?
Why do we have time?
We were just talking about you and rape and thinking about if you didn't show up, we were all going to gang rape you.
Yep, and how you wouldn't fight it.
I'll leave then. One second.
Oh.
Go ahead and get the anal leaves.
I'm trying to catch them ropes.
So, Neil, I've started on your little friendship bracelet thing.
Yeah, I can't wait. I'm going to put on my keychain. It's going to be orange and black. Trick or treat, motherfuckers.
Yeah.
You guys are all breaking up for me. I can't hear shit.
Oh, your computer shit.
That's because there is
my internet connection. Yeah. Is shit.
Is she streaming that show?
Yeah, last week my wife was watching something on Netflix and I couldn't even get anything going out here.
Hogging all that bandwidth.
Yeah.
Have you heard about that throttling shit that's going on with that shit? The ISP throttling people's connections and saying that they're not, but they are.
That shit is illegal as fuck.
Yeah, I have Fios out of all things, and that shit happens to me just on that. I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, it's happening out here in West Texas.
$100 a month for fucking internet.
Yeah, same shit.
I got that Comcast.
Oh, Comcast, that sucks.
Dude, I get eight megabytes download a second. Fucking shit be balling.
Is that good?
8 megabytes a second? That's pretty fucking blazing. For around here, at least.
Mine's 25, and that's with a 4-bar connection stealing internet.
Well, yeah, see, you got that bootleg bandwidth.
No, I got that bootleg Fios that works real good.
Real good.
I like it.
All right, I want to say this about trannies.
Whoa, Someone's got the tip on the mind.
He's still got it on his mind.
In my bar, there's a dude who comes in, and he doesn't come in as much anymore, but he used to come in all the time for fucking years, and he was an ex-Navy SEAL. His name was Chris Beck, a really close friend of mine. Like, he slept on my couch after drinking a shit ton of times. This is, like, dude, like, SEAL Team 6. This motherfucker has, like, been up in Iraq and fucking everywhere you can imagine killing motherfuckers. He's still super cool. Like, I've gotten shit-faced drunk with him a shit ton of times. Like, a year ago, he comes up to me and a bunch of some other people that he knew, and he goes, like, I'm transgender. I need to be a woman. No fucking shit.
Go ahead.
Wow.
That's nuts.
Motherfucker wears a dress now and, like, had his fucking weebie chopped off.
Oh, no.
Oh.
He went full. He's fully invested.
He went full.
Oh.
Damn.
I do not endorse chopping your wee-wee off.
No.
Well, I'm just saying, if you walk up to somebody who used to be a man and try to fuck with them, they might be a Navy SEAL who could kill you in, like, 50 different ways.
Good point.
Because now you're getting your ass kicked by a girl, so.
What fucked me up is, like, this dude wants to chop his dick off. What am I talk shit to him? This motherfucker's probably, I never asked him, but he's probably killed, like, 100 people that he's, like, looked at their face and, like.
Wow.
I think the world record guy was.
Like, fucking go ahead, chop your dick off.
Killed was, like, 100 or something.
Go ahead.
That's like a Glenn Quagmire's dad on Family Guy. He's a woman.
Oh, yeah.
He came home and became a woman.
That's right.
And then Brian slept with him.
Yeah.
I remember that. Thanks for the sweet art.
But that is a rager that you have in your mouth. It's all pink.
That's a weird shade of pink, man.
It's some Picasso art right here.
Picasso.
Yeah.
There you go.
That looks like an Ed, Ed, and Eddie dick. Like that type of art. Like that kind of artwork.
Yeah.
Yeah,
who drew
it? It was either Dan or Derek.
No, I did not draw it. Derek, is
the best. Derek, I think Dan is the best.
On this one.
Your dick was drawn by Plank.
Yeah. Ed, or Eddie. Could have been one of
Hey, Josh, is that Patrick Henry on your left arm?
No, it's Johnny Cash.
Oh, Johnny Cash, okay. It's not entirely clear.
Oh, yeah, awesome, all right. It's time to erase that masterpiece.
Awesome. It was his portrait on Time magazine when he died. Yeah. I've also got Willie Nelson and Waylon Jennings.
That is totally awesome.
Oh, dude, those are all the best.
Son, you need to be in Texas hanging out with us. I hang out with the Waylon Jennings family all the time.
Willie Nelson.
Dude, that's cool, man.
Wait, I gotta stand up something. I might bust my fucking head open.
Wait.
Are you gonna do a handstand?
You guys like this leg? What's up? You guys look at my crotch?
Oh, is it? That's a nice one.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Is that Macho Man Randy Savage?
Yeah.
Or is that Jesus?
We can't do it.
It's Flaccid Man.
That's Waylon.
There's Waylon. Never could walk the lawn. And there's Willie.
Hell yeah.
And here's Willie, and here's my mushroom town.
Dude, fuck yeah.
That is awesome, man. I had a lot of respect for you, but now I have even
just
more.
Kidding. She thought it was my dick, but it's my finger. How about that shit?
Oh my gosh. Wow.
What happened?
Hold me for a second.
Oh my god. This is what happens when I turn draw on.
Admiral Akbar. Right.
It's a trap.
Alright. I see a little kid, so watch your language. Oh, she can't hear.
She can't hear. She hears it enough for me anyway.
Yeah, I'll wait here.
Hey, what's up?
I'm gonna roll out for a second. I'm gonna restart my modem, and maybe that'll fix my shit because I can't hear anything anybody's saying.
It's just
I'll be back.
Netflix that's
restart. Yeah, the Netflix.
He's gonna have to get her off of the bandwidth.
Oh, she might not see my screen.
Yeah, don't.
Scarf for life.
Let's go.
That's absolutely awful.
Here we go. I'll be right back.
After that.
I saw where Dan drew a nice penis on the stuff that he sent to 6'4" Honda. So.
Oh, dude, that cracked me up so hard.
Oh, my gosh. And, like, 6'4" Honda was so confused. He was like,
yeah.
And it's a picture of a penis. It's
yeah.
Okay, thanks, man. Let's go to the picture of the penis.
He's just like, all right, we're done. We're done with this fan mail. Dude, you should send him one every week.
No, it's so much money. I'll just drive to his house and put it in his mailbox.
How is it so much money to mail stuff within Canada?
No, it'll be a few bucks each.
What? That Canadian Post.
Yeah, man.
Yeah. Well, I've gotten a whole bunch of stuff from subscribers. Man, I got this guy sent me a book on, because he knows I'm a Freemason. He sent me a book on Freemasonry that's all written in German. I got some BMW posters. Somebody that are coming from somebody. I got a whole bunch of stuff to do a vlog on it.
I got.
What's going on over there, Dan?
Yeah. Well, my friend's over, and he just told me the best pickup line. You want to hear it?
He told you the best pickup line?
Yeah, go ahead.
Is he 17 too? I can guarantee you it's not.
No. Okay. Listen. Okay. On a scale of 1 to Murica, how free are you tonight?
Go ahead.
Nothing.
Nothing? Is that that's a punchline?
Uh-oh. Tip.
Tip? Derek, are you gay?
Tip dispenser. Oh god!
Oh my gosh!
What happens?
Mm-hmm.
Who's writing all that shit?
Dan.
I'm gonna match the handwriting.
It's BBC.com.
Oh my god!
Dude, they're having their own conversation over there.
I know, Dan. You're out of this.
Yeah, I have a friend over, man.
Oh, okay.
Somebody asked, if you could get any bike right now, what would it be?
Who are you asking? Everybody?
Everybody. Go ahead. Dream bike. If you just have just endless money.
I'd get a pink Vespa.
That's no surprise.
With flowers hanging off the handlebars.
I like it.
I love the idea of that. It's very soothing.
Yeah, how about you guys?
Oh, I know what I would want.
What?
My dream bike is a 1982 Kawasaki Eddie Lawson replica, the real Eddie Lawson replica from the early 80s. Let me see if I can find a picture of it.
Hey, Josh is back.
Fuck yeah, man. I had to reset my modem. I couldn't hear anybody.
I bet it's Jessica with that Netflix drawing all the bandwidth, dude.
But now you guys sound great, so especially I couldn't hear you, Tim, and I was like, man, Tim's got like this radio announcer I'm gonna talk about like all sexy and shit into the fucking thing. I was like, man, I can't hear that dude at all.
It's Jessica, working now here. Though.
It's Tim, say hi to Tim.
What's up, hi, Tim. Jessica?
You gotta get up here. Here, look.
How you doing?
Good.
Awesomeness.
That's Living Rob. That one right there.
How's it going?
That's Baker Derek.
I've seen that.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's Dan, the guy from Canada. Okay. Like 16.
Hi.
Dick.
You don't need one.
Come downstairs.
Hey, what kind of wine are you drinking tonight, Jessica?
It's called Fat Bastard, actually.
Whoa.
Don't. Sucking on that fat bastard, what's up?
Easy, man.
Don't leave.
Let's all go ahead and take it easy.
Yeah.
You having a nice day in Anchorage?
Oh, yeah.
Jesus.
Nice.
Wait. No, you sons of bitches.
Oh my gosh.
I've always wanted a Prilla. I think I'd get an RSV4. Those things just look BA.
There you go. Fat bastard.
Can you see it?
Oh, that looks fancy. That made in Compton? City of
Dude, that's what Jessica calls all the fat black chicks walking down the street in War City. She's like, what's up, Rhino Rally? Looks like hungry hippos up in your fucking yoga pants.
Oh, God. She's got all kinds of terrible in here.
Jessica used to be kind of chubby back in the day, so she's fucking real hard. Huh?
What do I call people?
Rhino Rally?
Oh, yeah.
Black chicks?
Yeah.
The fucking with their yoga pants?
No, we're fat
people. Poor fat people. They don't have to be black girls, but.
Oh, God.
You just turned it 120% racist.
Oh, God. Terrible.
All right. Here's my dream bike.
There it is. Mean Green.
She it says is, it's man. Not always black girls, it's just angry girls.
Angry big girls.
Angry big girls.
All right.
All right, she's gone now. It's totally black chicks.
There's mine.
Yeah, all right. You got the Kawasaki penis going now.
Give me that one.
Oh, this is, wait.
That's that Hulk.
Oh, the RSV4.
Oh, man, when I was buying all those toys for you guys at the toy store that I had in my most recent moto vlog at the end, there was actual. I've never actually seen anything like these before, but I can only call them Baker X Derek Goody Holes. They're these little rubber things that have liquid in them, but they roll like a, I don't know. You can put your finger in them, and they're real weird and stuff. I don't even know what they are, but I should have bought some, but I didn't. But I will.
Nice. What is Josh doing over there?
Nothing.
Can you not hear again?
It sounds like someone's talking in the background of all this. Somebody
yeah, because I'm talking to my friend.
That's Dan's buddy going, ma, 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 ma,
Yeah, tell your friend to shut the fuck up.
I have to have dick in my mouth.
Whoa!
I don't know why everybody makes it out to be a big deal. It's just some dudes hanging out with other dudes, like doing dude stuff. And like maybe you want to feel good, so you know, you're like, hey, bro, what's up?
Dropping the knowledge.
It's all good till Dan's mom busts in and the truth's out.
Yeah, what's that? Want some tech?
No. And then I start getting beat with a pizza roller.
I've got this fantasy about Dan's mom. I'm sorry. Dan, okay. Can you describe your mom?
What?
Yeah.
Please nope.
Describe.
Is she tall? I mean.
No, she's shorter than me. She's like.
Oh, really? Pocket size, huh?
5'3"? 5'4"? Okay, 5'2", 5'3".
What Josh is really driving at is post a picture of your mom for us.
That's the bottom line.
Tim the Thief taking words right out of my mouth.
Trying to get some MILF Goody Hole going on.
MILFs are the best.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it wouldn't be that weird, Dan, because I'm 31. Tim's in his 40s. Like, one of us could date your mom.
I'm probably older than Dan's mom.
Well, I'm 25 and my parents are still in their 40s, so you're probably right.
Yeah. It's just impossible for me to think of myself as being in my 40s. I know I am, but I don't have kids. I mean, I've just kind of been 25 for the last 20 years, you know, 18 years.
You did life right.
I did.
And then later in life, when you have nothing better to do, go ahead and shoot them ropes and have a couple kids. And
you call it shooting ropes?
That's what you call it. Shooting
some
ropes.
Shooting
some ropes.
Oh, man.
Neil knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, man.
See, he's got his rope protectors on his eyes right now.
Yeah.
Well, he's got some fucking, like, getting laid protectors on. His girlfriend's in the background. If she heard this shit, it would be like, I ain't touch your pee-pee forever.
It's even funnier when you can see her back there not knowing anything we're saying.
So they're, like, texting and be like, oh, my gosh, yeah, I had fucking noodle soup today, too. And Neil's over here being like, yeah, throwing ropes, what's up? Hit that.
Got more ropes than a mountain climber.
So did you like show her Willow? I noticed you post on Facebook she's never seen Willow before.
Yeah, I did. We watched it yesterday. Willow. Okay, cool. How have you not seen Willow? Have you guys seen Willow?
Has she seen Princess Bride?
Oh, dude, Princess Bride, of course. I made her watch that too.
Right.
Classic.
She's off the hook, man.
Well, we still watched it together. I know, look, talking shit back there. Don't get crazy. No, but yeah, we did watch Willow, and she agreed it was awesome.
Yeah.
Unless she was just saying that to appease me, because it has midgets.
She's probably back there watching the live stream on her iPhone.
Motherfucker might be in trouble, if that's the truth.
Yep.
Tim, did you add Neil's girlfriend? I was about to, then I was like, man, that's kind of weird.
Like Jessica knows who I am.
I'm not talking shit.
Yeah, well, I thought about it, but I also balked on that because, you know, like Jessica knows who I am, but Kai doesn't, and she'd be like, man, who's this creepy dude, you know, friending me for no reason? So I figured I'd hold off on that.
Dan, she was talking about your little comment you left on her beer review vid. Right in the mouth. Quote. I go, that's Dan. That's where he loves it.
Excuse me?
Oh, wait, you're too busy talking to your boyfriend back there.
Yeah, exactly. Like, you gotta speak louder. He's yelling.
Dan, it's okay that you're gay. Nobody cares. Like,
we accept you.
2014, nigga. Come on.
2014.
Right. We're past that stuff as a society. You can be who you are, brother.
Yeah. Well, I'm straight, but I like drawing mushroom tips.
So you're like the dude from Superbad.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh yeah, I forgot about that. He was obsessed with it.
Dude, I've drawn so many dicks on bathroom walls, it's not even funny.
It's all my hand knows how to draw.
Yeah. Oh, Josh.
Everyone's like, oh, you fucking run a bar, or you should be the best bar patron ever. I'm the worst, motherfucker.
You're taking out all your passive aggression when you're not on the job.
Ah, dude, I've been thrown out of so many fucking bars, this shit ain't even funny. You draw like a coupe.
It's a Taco Bell.
That's a big mushroom.
God, is that beautiful? I'm drawing penises on the screen. That's all these live streams of goddamn turned into is penises.
Penis
drawing. It's all my fault. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
You don't sound sorry, Dan. You don't sound sorry at all.
Because I'm not sorry at all.
What happens?
He looks like the Grimace from McDonald's right now.
With a tip on his face.
And I'm not trying to. I'm having a great time. But does anybody actually ask questions about motorcycles? Like,
we can talk about motorcycles.
A bunch of people have been in the comments. Oh, nice ridges on there.
Ruffles got ridges. Things like we're supposed to. I'm not trying to get on that. Like, but are we supposed to answer motorcycle questions or something?
Yeah. Look, guys, I'm gonna have to get going.
What?
You get to go.
Just got here.
That's lame.
I've got other business to attend to.
What, like high school?
Hey, M tips.
You've got prostates to rub.
Prostate.
Everybody knows you've got to be at homeroom tomorrow. Come on.
Dan, let me know which one of those toys you want from at the end of my latest moto vlog for when you send me the friendship bracelet, man.
Oh yeah. I'm not sure.
Okay.
Did anybody call those out yet? Like anybody?
Nobody has. I figure everybody would want the Shade Tree Surgeon replicas first. Well, but, yeah, whichever one you want, just they're not all in that one shot, but you can see most of them. So when I send you your sticker, I'll send you a toy with it.
You got to tape that to your motorcycle.
Yeah.
Other toys?
Yeah, you can have your choice. Just go back and look at it and tell me which one you want, and I'll send it to you.
Damn, okay, cool. Well, any really. You could just surprise me, and then I'll get one that... that you chose yourself, and it'd be awesome.
All right, I will do that. Consider it done.
Sounds like a good idea there, buddy.
Taco Cock.
Golly, man.
Where's the shell on it? Oh, you need like a shell on this.
Do you have a
white paint tool?
It looks like Darth Vader supporting breast cancer or something.
It is. That's exactly what it is.
This is a fucking dark helmet over here. What's up?
Well, we take a 5-minute break.
Pink tube.
Okay, guys. Well, I'll see you guys in a week. I'm not going to be here for next week's moto hangout, but I'll be back in 2 weeks' time. I'll be back on around Tuesday to Wednesday.
You're going on your vacation?
Yeah, vacay tomorrow, waking up at about 4 o'clock.
Cheer.
Yeah, right. So I'll see you guys. Fun,
peace out. Thanks, man.
Later. Be safe.
Bye. I'll try. Motorano video coming Wednesday.
Yeah, I'll release that shit. Your videos are way cooler than 644 Hondas.
I'll keep my eyes out. Girlfriend just goes, is that a Vader dick? obviously, she was thinking exactly what we were thinking.
All right,
I made that taco shell though.
Yeah. It's beer time. I'll be back in a sec.
Jessica had to go to the fucking grocery store to get me some more beers.
You made her go get you more beers? It's a nice girlfriend right there. Hey, drop what you're doing and go to the store for me.
She's well trained. What?
Whoa, easy. Go ahead and take it easy.
Kidding.
Derek, somebody asked, they wanted you to tell the story of how, like, you were at that homeless camp or whatever, and some people were talking with you or something. That's what they want, the story. Story time. Drop it.
Yes.
It was a dark, gloomy San Bernardino day. I was in that exact same area, and I rolled through there, and since it was my first time, and I saw all those homeless, like, makeshift houses, and I thought they looked fucking cool as hell. They were all, like, they're all professionally made and shit, and, like, one of them had a cool little, like I said, he had, like, a little target archery board and shit, and I was all going to it and looking at it, and then once I got down where that freeway part was, there's like about three or four of them that came out, and I hope I didn't delete the video. I can't find it, but I had it on video. And then basically we just started. They asked me why I was riding through there, then and why I had a camera on my helmet. They saw that shit immediately, and I just said I make videos on YouTube and that I'm just riding through there, and they all had fucking like bats and shit, but they didn't. To do anything, but they you could tell they were trying to like intimidate me and make me fucking seem like
they thought you were like the FBI fucking coming for their ass.
Yeah, an FBI with a fucking little dual squirt.
Homeland Security.
And then that is the dope bit. But I had it on video, but I can't find it.
Just do a reenactment.
Yeah.
You had that one dude in that homeless camp video up on top of his giant Fallout 3 hill shaking his fist at you. He wanted to get out of there.
That exact spot where he was standing is where those other three people were standing on the other video.
Yeah.
That took place right in that like identical spot.
Fucking hills have eyes.
On top of that brown little spot I showed where that brown looking wall house thingy, on the other side of the hill where the businesses were, there's like a whole row of other little encampments, and there was a lady and two dudes there on that side, and they came out too, and they were all tripping balls over it. And it's just a fucking open field, like as if they own it. That's what's funny, how they were acting towards me about it, and trying to act like they're gonna fucking hurt me or something about it. That's what I laughed about.
Well, I mean, they're hobos, so they don't care, so they might have.
Oh yeah, yeah. Obviously, but
yeah, hobos don't give a fuck.
That's right. They're a couple of tacos short of a combo plate, man. You got to be careful with those people.
Sure. I know there's some legitimately homeless people out there, but
yeah,
I don't give a fuck with that shit. I've gotten so many fights with homeless people in Ybor City. It's Ybor City is where my bar is like Bourbon Street in New Orleans. So there's like homeless people out the ass.
Bring them some tacos.
Dude, I don't give a fuck, dude. I will bounce those motherfuckers down onto the curb so fucking hard. not even, you don't even have to care. They're not even like real people.
Oh, no.
Those motherfuckers, dude, I don't have to care because it's like, okay, you would feel bad for them. Like, all you guys would go like, oh, that poor homeless dude is all crusty and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, motherfucker, I'll kick that dude's knees out and fucking roll him onto the street. I don't give a fuck. Because I know that motherfucker makes like $250 a night and spends it all on heroin and a hotel room. Like, I don't give a fuck. Don't do it in my fucking bar.
That's true. They did like a news thing here, and they're like, oh, these fucking panhandlers making like $80K.
There was a real famous panhandler here in West Texas who would go out and panhandle all day, and they followed him home one day, a news crew did, and he lived like in a regular house. I mean, it wasn't a fancy house, but he lived in a regular neighborhood. He had a bank account and all that stuff, and he would just go out and panhandle every day. He'd make like 100 to 700 or 800 bucks a day panhandling every day, sitting around doing nothing. It's crazy, man.
Dude, that's what I'm going to start doing.
The people in Ybor City don't do it to, like, actually make money. They do it to buy drugs. Like,
oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
to do heroin. But heroin's fucking expensive.
What's up, Cars on Cars?
What's up?
There he is. Stuck
his way in here.
Yeah, I just snuck my way in here. I was asking Dan for a link and everything, and he sent it to me, and I'm like, oh, I'm doing homework. And so I just finished now putting together a binder.
You doing all kinds of bindering over there.
Oh, yeah. I bought, like, 20 tabs for this one class. Like, just in just one binder. It's for one class.
What's a class?
Criminal investigations.
Is that like CSI?
Yeah, and then at the end of the year, we go see an autopsy.
Oh, man.
Internal investigation? You like the cops for the cops?
It's like the nerds for the cops. I don't want to be doing it, but I have to take it for my GE.
Does that mean you have to stick your finger in the corpse's gooty hole?
No, actually,
is that like a requirement of the class?
Actually, you just like stand there and look. He gives you extra credit to go to the autopsy, and like the extra credit counts for like you can stand there and then like walk away after 3 seconds of not liking it or something. And it's like a test grade, and so I'm just gonna go to it because I've always wanted to see
that. Oh, you must see this dead body. He probably like gets off on it. The teacher.
My teacher.
You get extra credit if you poke it or something.
Yeah.
You can get extra credit if you go, but my teacher's like this old retired Italian investigator.
Extra credit if you throw some ropes on it.
I'll do this. How far are we into this? Like we're like an hour into it.
I believe Almost. So.
All right, so I can show you guys something because I guarantee nobody watches this past like 10 minutes.
We actually have 22 watching right now.
Are you fucking kidding? I was like, I'm gonna like show some like weird fucking shit that might be against the law, but like, I don't want anybody to see that shit.
It's not gonna be like GG Allen again, is it?
22 people in here watching are gonna give two rats dickheads about what you show.
Unless right, it's like
I'm gonna go get it. I'll be right back.
Uh-oh. It's gonna be a double-sided dildo copter or some shit.
Yeah.
Oh my god. Gosh, I went back and watched a video parts in his house.
Yeah, that video is pretty classic.
Yeah, I've never seen it before then.
I remember seeing it back in high school and just remembered it like a month ago and looked it up and popped it's right up there. And laughed even harder, I think, than I laughed even back then when I watched it.
Alright, check this out. I fucking bought this out of the back of a car.
Watch him show like a key and fucking...
Yeah, it's like a dehydrated penis.
A baby? What?
I was going to do a moto vlog about it, so for people. Like, look at the teeth.
What is it?
They're you all got a hard time. It's for real, a human skull.
Oh.
What? Dude, I've always wanted a human skull. You have one? Oh, shit. Is that real?
Hey, look at that shit right there. Like, the teeth are all rotted out. That one's all fucked up.
What the fuck?
You can tell, and I know the difference now because I've researched it. I bought this, like, 10 years ago. And so the difference between this one and a regular one is the regular ones that you can buy on the internet are white, like they belonged in some sort of weird-ass, like, you know, they were in a medical school. Yeah, this one's got dirt. This one was taken out of the ground because it's got dirt in all the crevices. Like, somebody grave robbed this shit.
So you bought it. How much did you buy it for?
How much did you get that hooker skull for?
Look, you got. That was a dude.
Yeah, right.
Isn't that crazy?
Like we said,
I've had this shit forever.
Flip it over, made in China.
You know what? You know what's inside it? A screwdriver.
Oh. You should eat your cereal out of it in the morning. Yeah.
If you were badass, you would eat.
That would be my regular cup. I would always drink out of that.
Yeah. You need to put that on the front of your bike and just.
The thing, that skull probably ate out and fucked so much gooty hole in its leg.
I can't hear
every
anything.
Morning. I would just have that thing full of apple jack.
Yeah, you probably got AIDS just touching it.
Yeah, it's Jessica's Netflix. No, I said I would have that thing full of Apple Jacks and
before,
milk
before,
and
Jessica can't hear me, so I'll see this now. When I used to have chicks over that I was fucking, you know, giving the old one to, I'd have them over here. I'd be all drunk, and I'd be like, before we go to my bedroom, you have to touch this. And I make him touch it. And then we fucking bang.
That's really like Camarillo Blow.
Oh, man.
Dude, I know shit. I bought that thing for $150 out the back of a, like a 1978 Impala.
So, good thing I remember the car.
That was some weird shit. The dude had like a shit ton of skulls in the back of his car. He had ones that were like had all sort of gold teeth. He had violent death skulls all over the place. Those were like fucking $500 or $600, like bullet wound skulls, or axe wound, or machete wound, or stab wound. Like, those things were expensive.
Right now, 14 years. And gosh. Dirt bike. I never rode a dirt bike.
What?
Huh? I never rode a dirt bike.
It's a ghost of that dead guy. That was coming off of Derek's channel.
I just realized that shit was playing right now, and I paused it. How long was that playing for?
Not very long.
I was on the other feed reading comments, and I thought Shade G was talking all around.
I need to go to that other feed and read the... Is anybody asking questions? We got 20 or 30 people out there. They might be wanting us to actually talk about motorcycles.
As long
stuff.
As nobody calls the cops on my fucking human skull. I was... Think if my house burns down, I'm going to have some fucking questions to answer.
Oh, Neil, Joe isn't coming today because he's, like, in the dunes or something.
Yeah, he's on vacation.
Oh, is he?
Yeah.
Nice. Somebody just goes, Kevin Westwood just goes, he could tell ropes on it. Or I could tell he threw ropes on it.
It's been in my hand while I've been naked and I have an erect penis. That's happened.
That's why there's an extra hole in it.
That's the only way to have it.
Really? Oh, man.
All right, if you guys out there watching, ask some questions, in the comment.
Tampa is like the goth capital of the fucking world. So, yeah, I've been holding a human skull while my dick's been hard in Tampa. So,
I want to see some pictures of Jessica in her full goth getup, man.
Oh, she was goth as fuck, dude. You have no idea. Wearing, like, bustiers and, like, nothing but black lace and, like, all this fucking shit. Like, nuts.
So you're telling me you can hold that skull without getting an erection?
That was fucking perfect.
He grabs that piece of it and snorts it.
It's hard.
Shit.
Yeah. Oh my. Seriously, I probably just fucked up by showing that shit. I'm probably going to get like a fucking police call or some shit.
You know, that's the coolest thing I've ever seen, I think. That thing is badass.
Nobody watches this anyway, so you're good.
Whoa.
It's not a big deal. All I did was, like, exchange money for it. Like, it's not like I fucking killed a dude.
Yeah. Actually, he did.
Wait, was he alive when you handed the money over, or was he already dead?
Or did you then rip his head off?
No, he was totally into it, man. Dude had a trunk full of skulls.
That
I'll tell you this. Like
crazy,
I said, he had, like, a dozen violent deaths. Skulls. He had a bunch of skulls where, like, had all this gold and silver filigree, and the top was on a hinge, and they had all gold teeth and gold eyes. This motherfucker had all sorts of skulls. It was not weird to him at all.
Were any of them bedazzled or bejeweled?
Yeah, all the Tibet skulls, they were all fucking bedazzled. They had, like I said, they had all Tibet. That gold filigree all over them. It was crazy. Those things were like $4,000.
Wow.
How'd you find him, or did he just come up to you, or what?
I used to be really into the body modification scene.
Oh, so.
And some of the dudes who are really into the body modification scene used to be into wet parts. And wet parts are essentially like, you know, if you have to go into the hospital and somebody, like, if you're diabetic, like, they have to cut your toe off, or your foot off. or if they have to like cut your dick off, schools out, or like tumors or cysts and shit like that. And there's a market for it. If you can get those, if you can steal those, you can sell them. And I used to know a guy and do some stuff for a guy with the wet parts, and that's how I met the skull dude.
Ah. Oh, dude, you should get some wet parts and just, like, throw them off your bike when you're riding around, just like, boom, right in somebody's convertible a tow.
You would never throw that shit off. You can make so much money on that shit.
So what would like, a tow go for? If you have to go to the doctor
and have to take one of your testicles out or some shit like that for, like, testicular cancer, keep that shit because you can...
You just, like, freeze it and keep it fresh or what?
Put it in formaldehyde.
Yeah, have it in
formaldehyde. Yeah, somebody asked me why I don't wheelie, and that's because I don't want to flip my fucking shit over and kill myself. Because I probably would. I don't trust myself on the Z yet, or I don't feel comfortable enough on the bike. I've only had it since last summer.
If I had your bike, I couldn't help myself. That bike's a wheelie machine.
Yeah. It doesn't go up as like I guess as easy as you think. When I had my 1000RR, I could do it just like throttling, and it would just whoop like easily, and I could do it on that. But I don't know about the Z. I think I need to adjust the fuel controller. It doesn't feel right to me.
I feel like your Z will fucking pull it right up if you just open it up, though.
Man, well, it doesn't feel the same.
A little clutch up on this in second would probably do it good for you.
Mm-hmm. Really. I don't even know, like, what do you, like, rev it to? I'm afraid to, like,
I only wheelied my ZX a couple times just for that identical same reason, because that bike would literally just be pretty much done if it crashed from any wheelie, but having the bars you got, and, like, as much as I like to wheelie my little DR200, I can't really wheelie it past first gear because it's so fucking underpowered, but for a first gear, I mean, you can do a pretty fun little wheelies on it, but, for what that seating position is, I'm pretty sure it'll be a lot more helpful for you, especially in sitting back and pulling it up.
Yeah, I'll probably try it before summer's over. Just like some.
I wouldn't worry about it if you fucking don't even want to do it.
Hey, Derek, I wanted to ask you about your DR200. Are you just power wheeling it? Are you clutching up?
No, I clutch up big time on that.
Okay.
That bike only has 15 horsepower. You got to clutch the crap out of it.
I've even done hardcore clutch up sitting literally almost on the fucking rear ass fucking brake light, like banking it on second gear, and it rarely even comes up. So it's pretty underpowered. I'm pretty sure though, like I am 206 pounds. So if somebody like 130, because if you don't remember that video I did, I rode that two stroke Kawasaki. My buddy was riding my DR, and he weighs 130. And believe it or not, he was on that bike keeping up with me and my buddy on this WR250. And obviously we weren't romping hard, but we were still going. And that thing was way faster with him on it than me on it. So with him, it might actually be possible, but with me, fuck no. I'm too heavy for that shit on that bike.
Somebody asked you what bike you ride.
A Rocket 3.
Rocket Tree. There you go, Zevi 100.
Oh, Velocity says craziest chick stories, and I think I have a good one.
Oh, God, I ain't trying to get into that.
Oh, okay, I got a good one. So, since no one really watches this that I went to school with, so it's, I had this one girlfriend, she was Vietnamese and Chinese, right? So, you know, I didn't know, like, she had been in and out of a mental hospital for, like, a couple weeks or a couple months. And so I ended up getting with her, and then I found out, like, I tried breaking up with her, and I could not break up with her because she'd come to my house and, like, sleep outside my house in her car.
Nice.
That's
true love, baby.
Oh, yeah. And so last year, my friend on Twitter sent me the address to the house he was going to be having a party at. So I go to the house, and then... As I'm getting there, like, I get inside, you know, we're hanging out, and then I hear the doorbell ring, and I'm closest to the door, so I go and get it. It's my girlfriend, or ex-girlfriend at the time, and she just showed up, and I'm like, how did you find the address? She's like, I looked on your Twitter and found it, and all this other shit. I'm like, oh my God.
I'm so glad that social media shit wasn't around when I was going through school. I mean, it was, but it wasn't even remotely as popular as it is today.
And dude,
cars on cars, you just got to play it right. You can bang that chick whenever you want.
Oh, but after that, I didn't want to. You know, that was the thing. It was like that, but after that, no. But She was like the most amazing artist I've ever met. And
they always are. They always are.
Let me show you a picture of what she. Oh.
Yeah, I think all women are. They got that delicate hand stroke in all occasions.
I'm gonna put on
the craziest bitch I ever dated was a fucking amazing artist.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
And that chick sucks. She can fucking burn in hell and sucks cock.
But she came in.
I thought you meant sucks in a good way.
Yeah, I was thinking that same thing.
Like she can suck the chrome off a trailer hitch ball.
But this girl, she drew me that picture of me, because I took a picture when I got my 650, and then I had that picture like as my profile picture on Facebook or whatever, and that was like that for a while. And so she's like, oh, I'm going to draw it for you. So she drew it for me for my upcoming birthday. And it was this beautiful sketch, and she destroyed it like 5 times, and then she kept making it over and over again. And so she came in and took it off my wall because my brother.
Satanism type shit.
Yeah, she went ahead and drew it in blood.
Oh yeah, she was crazy. Hold on,
The only crazy girlfriends I've had were Mexican. I've never had any crazy. My Asian.
Well, you live in fucking Cali. They're all Mexican.
Yeah. Well, they're all like fucking. They all live with cholo type families too, where I live too.
That's even creepier, because if you do one of those chicks wrong, they're fucking
cousins. I was actually scared. Yeah, I was scared to break up with my ex in middle school because of that. That show was a fucking shitty experience.
Hold on, let me get the picture.
Crazy Mexican with just a top button. All
speaking of him talking about...
Fuck out of you.
I guess since he told that story, I could tell a little one. The girl I just now talked about, but this was when I was in middle school, so we're kids. But... This girl I was with over a year, and we lived together, we lived literally a block apart. She was literally on the other corner in a house, and I was in an apartment complex. And I remember when we broke up, she would fucking come to the house. She knew the hours my mom worked. She knew my mom had a normal 8-to-5 job. So she would fucking come to that apartment and force herself in and lock the door and try to sit there and tell and convince me that I should get for hours, and I had to literally lock the door. And that was as a fucking middle schooler. But that was the only fucking crazy girl I've ever had that was that intense.
Yo, look at this.
Go ahead and get a taser.
Yeah.
Sure,
can you imagine that?
You can come in, just open the door, you just
hear...
Oh, that's a crazy good drawing, man.
Right?
Well, I feel like we're going down the line telling craziest girlfriend stories.
I like how you put 2 fingers over that face.
Yeah, I like how you cover up your drawing face.
Well, it looks exactly like me. It looks exactly like me.
That's a pretty legit drawing. Alright, Josh, you had one you were going to say?
No, we're going down the line. It's your turn, Neil.
No, Josh once shot some ropes in that skull and made his ex fucking drink it out of it. Huh?
I'll tell you this.
He's been filling up for weeks.
I don't have a whole lot of crazy ex-girlfriend stories, but there's a bunch of girls who have a crazy ex-boyfriend stories.
About you.
I'm a nightmare for chicks, man. But... Well, just because, where I work is, like, if you imagine the most popular place where you live, like, where all the... I'm not trying to sound like a badass, but where, like, all the fucking people hang out, that's where my bar is. So there's chicks there constantly, so it's not even a big deal. And so they're all, like...
Yeah.
I know how that goes.
Not anymore, though, because now I have Jessica.
Neil, I love how your girlfriend just sits and just reads books casually. Like someone you see in a detail or something. I never knew people did that stuff in real life.
I'm just back here reading books, getting all certain
shit. I couldn't read a book if you fucking paid me to do it.
What book are you reading, babe? Dante's Inferno.
Oh, nice.
Twilight. No, it's really Twilight.
Oh, crap.
How about you have her go play, like, Devil May Cry 4? And dude, that's pretty close, right? I've never played it, but I know it's something.
It's the girl who kicked the hornet's nest, which it must be about vaginas. Is that what it's about, babe? You look disgusted. And I guess it's not.
Why do chicks even bother with dudes, man? We're such idiots.
I think because of money.
That's part of it, probably.
Yeah.
Show her that shit.
Oh, she just goes, "You are all dicks."
That is not cool. Somebody drew a big wafting fart coming up off of her butt earlier.
Who did that?
It was probably Dan before he left.
That definitely wasn't me doing that.
It's a crying shame.
Babe, they want to know if you have any crazy stories. She said no.
Bullshit.
Ask her if what she's reading is what's showing up on screen.
Is she reading 50 Shades of Mushroom Tip? What's up?
50 Shades of Mushroom Tip?
Yeah. That's a diary of a mushroom tip. They want to know if that's what the book is about. And she said no. They said 50 Shades of Mushroom Tip. Also not.
What about 50 Shades of Goody Hole?
No, that was a bestseller.
That was a bestseller.
Oh my gosh. Alright, time for another beer. I'll be right back.
Beer it up.
He's like, "I'm gonna go ahead and get the fuck out of here."
Like, "Oh, maybe I'll join you on your live stream." I'm like, "It's pretty much he talks about penises and penis drawings."
How does anybody do this shit when they're not fucking hammered?
Exactly.
Oh, man. No. Yeah.
At least I don't got to go into work till 7 now.
Hey, Josh, when are you getting your Vegemite?
I think I've got, like, I don't know when. I ordered my shit, like, fucking 2 weeks ago.
Oh, you did?
What'd you order?
Vegemite for that shit that fucking some motherfucker from Australia posted.
Vegemite?
Eat a fucking spoon of Vegemite. And I was all like, "Man, I'm gonna fucking kill that shit. I'm gonna eat the whole fucking can. I'm gonna hammer it down in my gut."
What's a
and
Vegemite?
Then I saw fucking Livin' Rob do that shit, and he took like one bite and was thrown up.
Is that that crazy like German fish or something?
It's supposed to be.
No. It's a yeast extract. They make it into like, it's fucking disgusting. It's an Australian thing.
Ugh.
They spread it on toast, put it in like soups and stews. It's disgusting. Like
fucking, it's like kangaroo fucking goody.
Yeah, it's worse.
Goody.
I'm gonna try to hammer the whole fucking can into my gut.
Oh, God.
Dude. You would be the fucking man, dude. There's a Twisted Throttle, I think his name was. He ate a whole fucking can, but he's Australian too, so.
Oh, that don't count.
He grew up with that shit, you know.
Have you guys seen that? What it's that Swedish fish. They say it's like the most like stinky fucking shit ever. And you can videos on YouTube, people just like crack the can open and start vomiting. It's like some
Swedish or Icelandic?
I think it's like Swedish.
That shark? Oh.
No, it's like some kind of like fermented fish in a can or something.
Oh, that can't be good.
Yeah. What it is.
So I always call it when beer sucks. It's always like it's fermented fish piss.
Or it's Sir Stroming. The world's worst smelling canned fish.
Is that what it's called?
From Finland?
Maybe it is from Finland. No, it's Swedish.
That delicacy over there.
Soured herring.
Like canned fermented fish over in Finland or Sweden, one of those two countries.
It says strong, sometimes overwhelming odor, but look on YouTube, people just like fucking cracking cans. And
yeah,
just...
that's what it is then. Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
Oh, get some, Josh. Do that.
Oh, so they just crack the can and puke and shit? Or
like, dude, it's literally a can of, it's an airtight can of fermented fish.
Just like just straight rotten, and people pull it out, and it's like all slimy and
it's
shit.
Got, like black eyes, and you can see the spinal cords and shit. It's fucking disgusting, dude.
Oh yeah.
I almost threw up watching because I remember watching a video of like it was one of those challenge videos of some motherfucker having to eat some of it, and I remember just and I don't gross out over shit on videos, and that grossed me out. Just that little fucking video. you could just looking at it, you could get a sense of the smell just looking at it.
Derek, get some. Go out and give it to some.
Oh, fuck you, man. I wouldn't even.
No. Get some cans of it and, like, give it to some bums and be like, dude, this shit is fucking delicacy. And Hills Have Eyes will just be puking all over the mountains.
They would eat it up here, bro. All the fucking bums are native Alaskans. They eat some nasty shit, dude. Nasty shit.
Yeah, I heard they also make some nasty homemade alcoholic beverages up there, too.
Oh, dude. The fuckers, they're so crazy. They drink the sanitizer out of the toilet, out of the rent-a-cans.
Oh.
What?
I mean, they'll drink anything, I'm telling you. They
mouthwash, anything that has ethanol or methanol in it, they just drink
hairspray.
That stuff.
My mom is a state guardian up here before she retired, so she had a lot of Native Alaskans that were fucked. And
what's the state guardian do?
They basically, people that don't have family or anyone to take care of themselves, they're taken over. And if they can't take care of themselves, their money or welfare or any of that.
They basically are like a ward of the state.
They're a ward of the state, basically.
All right.
So she controls everything, their money, everything. And a lot of them are Native Alaskans, and they all get money from the state, so...
Does she know Sarah Palin?
my sister met her once, I know. I don't know.
Fuck dude, I live, like, not even I can't even say 2 miles from the Indian Reservation. You know what sucks is that's where probably the best dirt riding in the world is around me, and it's all fucking blocked off by fences and guard shacks and shit.
Yeah.
You can't even get in?
Yeah, dude, get this. The other day, I even have it all on video. I looked it up on Google Maps, and right up the mountain from me, right, not even 2 miles, there's an actual, I did an old vlog where there's this little creek of natural hot spring water that's literally like fucking boiling water where you can't even put your finger in it. It's that hot. Like, even for a second, it'll burn the shit out of you. It's that hot. And basically, that all leads to this it's a natural hot spring lake. So I was about to make a moto vlog there, and like, because that's pretty trippy, that's pretty cool, I like that, it's pretty dope, especially when you see it in person, but it smells like asshole. And
sulfur,
and I went there, exactly that's what it is. And I went there, and immediately right before I get there, there's a fucking fence and a guard shack, and I was fucking upset because I was excited. Dude, there's so much sick shit around here, but it's all Indian reservation.
Oh, man.
Just bust back there and see how far you get. They'll just keep
you. Dude, I've been thinking about it. Honestly, I already know a shortcut around it. So it's quite of a bit of a dual sport kind of adventure. Not really an adventure. What do you call it? Like an obstacle course. But I mean, if I can do it, it'd be pretty sick. I'll do it with me. That way, I have another fucking thing with me.
You got backup, so you just don't get beat up in a ditch somewhere.
Yeah. When you go into shit like that and you're breaking into Indian reservation territory, you gotta have a fucking other person with you.
The Indian reservations are crazy. Like, we have a casino up by ours, and
where
like,
you at?
There's a place called Sequoia Falls up by Shaver where I went. This is the shady one that I was talking about before. And like that's the one where they tied a sheriff to a tree for like 2 days. And then they shoot off guns and stuff over there. And
totally got away with it because they're Indians, right?
Yes. And, like, the sheriffs and CHP don't go over there anymore because they can't really regulate it legally and all that. So
well, the reservations, man, they have their own police. So if you go onto that land, you got to be careful because those cops, man, they play by their own
rules. Dude, they don't give a fuck. I've been beaten the fuck up by Indian police, man. Yep. Hey, dude, Indians anymore in 2014, that's white trash with a tan.
Yeah. Right where I was, right down the street, there's a tribal court right where the fucking Indian reservation starts. And it's literally a fucking, like a mobile home. That's what it is. And it's the tribal court.
Fucking white trash with a tan, dude. Yeah. Like, you all want to talk about, like, oh, we're connected with people who live out. Bullshit.
And they get, just and they get like,
dudes driving around lifted Broncos and shooting guns all day.
It's really, that's very true. Very
and
true.
How much money do they get a month for being
native? From the casino, if you're born Seminole in Florida, if you're born a Seminole, you get $50,000 a year, period. Right out of the bat.
And right there is more than like a lot of people that are doing fucking run of the mill jobs are making a year.
Yeah. Hell yeah. Right out of the bat, no matter what, $50,000 a year.
And they're literally sleeping on that money and fucking just getting it, scratching their
head. They all do pills. Like, they're all drug addicts.
There's a casino up in Prather, and it's called Table Mountain Casino. If you're just part of the tribe, you don't even have to participate in the casino. If you're part of the tribe, the lowest member makes $27,000 a month.
Shit. Jesus Christ.
And my grandpa's 75% fucking Indian. I gotta fucking get up on that.
But
all that's from, too, is gambling.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
From gambling.
We don't have the gambling up here. We have oil reserves, and there's some of the... I mean, they're rich. I mean, they're native corporations too. But
oh yeah, my heart right here is the San Manuel Casino. That's all fucking Indian shit. That's right where that tribal court is, right outside of the fucking front doors of the casino, out of all places.
Derek, if your granddad is 75%, man, you might check into that. You might be
entitled to a little mad money.
No, hell no, I'm not. My grandpa is.
Well, you only have to be like a 16th or something like that.
No, I knew a guy in high school that was a freaking...
Well, what's funny is my grandpa looks straight up like off a fucking Indian tribe, and I'm a straight up Casper White looking motherfucker, so we don't even like look related.
It don't matter if you can prove the lineage.
One guy in high school that was...
I bet the dirt under my balls is probably Indian, and that's about it.
Cousin Siobhan banged like 4 Indian dudes, and she gets a paycheck now.
Shit.
But I knew a guy who was 132nd Native American. He was
132nd?
Yeah, he had a card. He had a membership card for it. He is of the Choctaw tribe of Oklahoma. And he and his children, his future children, get free health and dental insurance for life.
Now, how much would I be if it's my mom's side father. She's at 75, but there's absolutely no other fucking Indians like, you know, my mom's side.
So, her dad was 75%. That makes her about 33 1/3.
My mom's lighter than me. I don't know how that plays out.
32 1/2.
So that makes you 6.
Derek, you're going to be 15.75%.
Derek, all you got to do is apply. You apply for that shit.
Living Rob's beating his kids, man.
I know.
Yeah, that makes you about 16 or 17%, Derek.
Oh, you're good. That's money.
That's money, dude.
You have to go up and fill out a form. You fill out a form like you're filling out a job.
Watch, like, a week from now, you see me on one of my videos and it goes, new bike reveal, and I have, like, an S1000 double R.
He's on a DR400 whipping a giant wheelie.
But some of the tribes only get benefits, though. Like, I knew my ex-girlfriend's grandma. My ex-girlfriend's grandma used to sell meth in her basement because she didn't make enough money from the.
That's what all these motherfuckers in Florida do, because they get because they were born, so they spend all that money. They might get $40,000 a year, but they spend all of it already. So they all fucking sell drugs and do all this crazy ass shit. It, like, $40,000 a year to them is like, no, that's just the money that comes in. I have to make more money on top of that because that money's spent.
Dude, that's more than I make. Fuck.
Well, yeah, but they've always gotten that, so it's not like that to them.
Bitches.
Yeah, there are no Indian reservations in Texas, but if you go next door to New Mexico, it changes real quick, and it's all Navajo there. And the closer you get, you know, into Arizona and all that, the worse it gets, the worse the reservations get. It's the worst. By the time you get almost to the Grand Canyon across New Mexico and into Arizona, it goes from pretty decent-looking reservations to complete squalor.
But they all have casinos, right?
Yeah, as far as I know. I know New Mexico does. They got a zillion of them.
They here, too.
Man.
Sevy wrote Baker X Indian. Go ahead and take it easy.
It cracks me up when people talk about going to gamble in Vegas. I'm like, you have to go to Vegas? Fucking Indian casinos everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, fucking A. But one thing that I can assure you guys is the machines here are fucking 100% tighter than the ones you'd find in Vegas. So I think it's worth your time just to go to Vegas, because out here, it's garbage.
Yeah, you can learn.
At least San Manuel, I can tell you that.
Our slots are real fucking tight, but when you go down and you like roll dice on craps, I mean, you can't fake craps. The craps is craps.
Sometimes on a payday, I'll go down, throw up like $20-$30 just for the fucking shit of it. Because I literally live a mile and a half away. Hold on. But, hold on. Go ahead. My bad. I have a call.
Our closest casino is like an hour away.
There's a bunch. My closest one is about an hour away. The closest one to me is in Hobbs, New Mexico, which is maybe 55 minutes, something like that. I never go.
Shit, mine's 5 minutes away, too. It's right down the street.
Fuck, I wish I had one around.
I'm anti-gambling. I hate freaking wasting money on that shit.
I just never win, so I stopped doing it a long time ago. I gave up on it.
I used to go a lot. I think I spent like $1,300 gambling.
Yeah, see, it seems so stupid. It's like,
I've never spent that much in my life.
You go buy a fucking school sport for that.
Well, no,
I'm a fucking horrible gambler. I bought Jessica's first bike from gambling.
Wow.
Nice.
No shit. It was a surprise. She don't even know this shit. Like, I went out to the... Sometimes I go after work, I'll go to the casino, and she don't fucking know. And I'll go there, I was rolling dice, and I fucking hit hard and won, like, fucking $3,500. And I was like, cool. The next day, I went out and I bought her a motorcycle.
She was like,
even though it was like a surprise, like I fucking left it at the house with like a bow on it and shit, and she like fucking didn't know it was gonna be there. She came home, she's like, oh my god, you bought me a motorcycle. And I was like, yeah, I got the money for that when I was drunk as fuck rolling dice on the top of my lungs.
Was that the Buell? That's
awesome.
That is
awesome. That was a Honda.
Well, what's up with that Buell? Why'd you treat it so poorly, man?
I buy like a couple motorcycles a month. I've always got like fucking 10 motorcycles in my backyard.
Oh, you do?
Nice.
That was an awesome.
Well, I sell them too. I don't just like buy them and keep them. Like I buy and sell them.
Yeah, yeah.
If I can make $100 off of doing it, like I'll do it. Like I don't make like a lot of money off it, but.
Is Waldo's Harley still running?
I lost money on a Buell. Obviously, I'm throwing it on the ground. I couldn't build the fucker, so I'm like, I'm gonna smash it.
Hey, Josh, is Waldo's Harley still running since he got it going?
No. I could fix that motherfucker in like 20 minutes, and he's let it sit for 3 months. Dumbest shit ever.
You cannot let him sit, man.
No, it's fucking his bike, man. I ain't going to fix it for him.
Oh, I can dig it.
Grab another dude's head.
A fucking foghorn.
Yeah. I couldn't even hear Josh. All I could hear was an airplane at Living Rob's house.
Yeah, he's got the fucking Chewbacca horn going.
You know, Living Rob lives right by the airport.
Oh, is it? I could do it. I do see one flying, though. Yeah.
That was
You got your bike outside behind you, Rob?
I thought they were blitzkrieging you.
Give us a live rev. Fire that bitch up.
Okay.
What was up with Homeboy last time, man?
What's that?
He was doing beats last time and fucking revving his bike.
Yeah.
Boy.
I think Echo Boy, he's coming, I think. I sent him an invite to his
bike. All right, we're going to hear Rob's bike with his DRZ up in Alaska.
Yep.
Running over moose.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's fucking, here, let me show you something. Let me see if this shows up. I'll show you my my badass muffler. My exhaust.
Yo, what's up? Why is it so light out over there?
Dude, it's still hot, 90 fucking degrees plus over here.
Megapipe 3000, I love it.
That's my custom fucking shit, bro.
Dude, that's
why fucking... Why is the sun still up over there, man?
That muff.
Alaska in the summer.
Is that what it's like? Like the sun's
going like
20 hours a day?
It's 5.
Dude, 40. It's 92 degrees here and the sun's up in San Bernardino.
Holy shit, the sun's still up there too?
Yeah, it's 92 degrees too.
Dude, it's dark as fuck here right now.
Well, I mean, it's like it's in the 90s here too, but the sun's down at least.
It's sunset here.
It doesn't get dark here.
It's 97 right now.
It don't get dark here till about 8 or 8.
Never mind. 99. It's 99.
It's 78 here. In the morning, it'll be like freaking 60.
What?
78? I wish it was fucking 78 here.
Me too.
Rob, in August, man, it's like the midnight sun right now, right?
Yeah, no, it doesn't get dark. It's just
it doesn't get dark at all.
Yeah,
so weird.
When I get up for work, it's gonna be 65, and it's gonna be all fucking T-storms tomorrow.
There's a moto vlogger called AK Deluxe Rider, and he has a video of him riding like at like 3 or 3:30 in the morning, and the sun's still up.
Yeah.
What?
Sup, guys?
There he is. I came to drop beats.
Boom, 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 boom.
I saw a guy at school today who had a shirt on. It said, murder beats, not people.
That's what's up.
Nice.
What up, Josh?
Yo, what's up, motherfucker? I was, like, talking about, like, what you did on here last week, like, all fucking week.
Were you really?
Yeah, that was, like, the coolest shit ever.
That's funny.
I tried to hit the trash can. I fucking couldn't. I'm sorry.
What's up, Derek? How are you?
In a second.
What's up,
dude?
Shit. Who else is in here? I forgot your name, Alaska.
Rob.
Rob.
How's it going, man?
Good to see you again.
Yeah, you too.
Living Rob, you're in a band too, ain't you?
Yeah, yep. I play bass in the band right now, but I play a little guitar and drums, actually.
Nice.
Oh, let's get a live jam going.
Dude, that'd be sick.
Lots of musicians in here.
Yeah, I talked about this in my last moto vlog, how I barely get along with musicians. It's weird that I'm friends with musicians on here, because normally I fucking hate them.
My whole life, that's venue owner, you evil bastard.
I run a bar. So, motherfuckers will show up, and I have to remind them, like, hey, look, dude, this is not your gig. This is my bar.
That's what's up. You tell them, Josh. Lay down the motherfucking law.
It's like, if motherfuckers want to roll up there with a guitar, turn it up to 11 like they're fucking rock stars and shit.
That's over with, man. You gotta. The only time I play a loud show anymore on the road is if it's a festival show, like that show that I did where Drowning Pool and LA Guns opened for us on Saturday night. That was a big loud show.
How did that go?
It was good, except for Drowning Pool's bass player destroyed my guitar rig.
Wow.
He was tearing all of his stuff down, and I was having my guys, I already told this before we went live, but I'll tell it again. I was having my guys bring my guitar rig up onto the stage, and I was on the side of the stage that Drowning Pool's bass player was on, and I was like, hey, man, I'm going to go ahead and start setting up right in front of you. And he was like, cool, man, I'm just tearing down. Do what you got to do, because anyway, they finished kind of late, and we had like 20 minutes to get started. So all these people are screaming and want me to come up to the front of the stage because they see me up there, and so I went up to the front of the stage and jumped down into the void to give a couple people hugs and say, hey man, I'm in a hurry, I gotta get going, you know, talk to you later or whatever. And right about that time I heard this giant crash, and fucking Drowning Pool's bass player's bass rig, one of the stacks, falls forward, and I've got my pedal board cover behind one of my amplifiers, and it smashes it like a beer can.
Damn.
And it knocks one of my amps over. It spared the other one. It didn't hurt either of the amplifiers, but I got to buy a new pedal board now.
That sucks, man.
Yeah. I mean, it was just an accident. They were cool about it and offered to pay for it and all that kind of stuff. But, God, that's just what happens when you try to do those shows with a bunch of big bands and you're trying and the stage manager's hurrying everything along. That's the kind of stuff that happens right there.
Yeah, for sure.
Hey, Tim, you don't have any roadies or anything, right? Like, you do everything yourself?
Yeah, well, what we try to do, we have a group of close friends in every part of Texas, and we try to get them to come help us Because we're not making the kind of money where we can pay. I mean, we kind of help out. We have a guy who goes with us who's kind of a road manager. But as far as people to help carry gear, I mean, you know, we always try to solicit people to help us do that. And this show that we played Saturday night, we actually had a bunch of friends come to that show because it was only about 100 miles from our hometown. So we had a lot of people to help us carry our gear, which is always
cool.
Roadies. Cool. Yeah, roadies.
Roadie, hey Echo, where's Sub D at? Why is he being a bitch?
He's at the pub, man. He kept trying to get me to come up to the pub, but I just got off of work and I grabbed a pizza and I came in. I was gonna finish editing this vlog, but I figured I'd jump on with you guys for a little bit before I do that.
I think that Echo Boy's got the coolest fucking background ever.
Yeah,
like some Darth Vader shit.
Oh, he's a mixer. Hey, fire the Death Star main laser. Take out Dagobah. I just blew the shit out of Alderaan.
Oh, shit.
Hitting those ladders.
Well, you could probably make money off of creating music for people on here, at least.
Oh, he's got the Vader, too.
You know what that is, Neil, right?
Look. Yeah.
Pez?
Is that Pez? Ah! I got the Chewbacca in the He's be on my desk at my old job.
Nice. All right, you ready for the next one? Here comes the next one.
Here's one. I got the chopper, Derek. If you make a paper mache, we can put it on here.
Dude, that's awesome.
I got a big chopper that I have like that.
Do you?
Yeah, that's a bigger one though.
Oh, see? Then what are you talking about? Just go ahead and paper mache a shell over it and just start flying that thing around.
Oh yeah.
Right into the homeless camp.
What up, Carson? How are you?
Good. How are you, man?
Good, man. Good to see you.
Good to see you too.
I thought
you were going to be in the dunes today.
Actually, I was in the dunes yesterday, and it was fucking amazing.
What? Do you take a sand rail over there or something?
No. You go through a park, and you go up and down all these crazy hills, and then you wind up on this dune that's 450 feet above Lake Michigan. And the crazy people barrel down it. I actually got footage of my brother-in-law. I put the GoPro on a stick for him, and he barreled down that motherfucker with the GoPro. So I'll be putting that up on YouTube at some point.
Oh, that's awesome. Neil,
you probably know what I'm talking about, don't you?
I think so. Yeah, there's a bunch of places around here, crazy-ass dune rides and all kinds of shit.
Yeah, we had fun, dude. I took the jet skis to Lake Michigan on Friday, or Saturday, my bad.
Oh, nice.
And the water was like 45 degrees.
No ice cream.
Ice cream? Is that what you're demanding?
That's all you get in a flower cup.
No, that was a personal exchange with my old lady about ice cream.
Where's my ice cream, goddammit?
He was all like, we're not buying ice cream every month. And I was like, dude, I will fucking buy ice cream every day.
Tim has returned.
Dude, people will be like, what'd you do after work? I was like, I don't know, I was drunk as fuck doing wheelies into the sitco, buying fucking two. Doing burnouts out of there, being like, what's up, about to go home and eat some ice cream so fucking hard!
Yeah. about to get live on that rocky road.
About to smoke so much weed and eat some ice cream. God, that's amazing. I don't even want it right now, baby. I gotta eat it later. I can't eat in front of my friends.
Yeah, dude, weed's good for the munchies, man. The munchies are actually a side effect.
This is so fucked up. Like, you can't eat ice cream in front of your dude friends like a bitch. You gotta eat it alone in private.
Just like when you eat a whole box of donuts crying behind the donut shop.
Well, Tim knows what I'm talking about.
Yep.
You can't fucking do it in front of your friends. That's something you do alone. Jessica! Take this away from me.
Damn.
Take this away from me.
God.
What's up, babe?
She brought it out while I was doing this on purpose to make me look good.
What are you doing?
What are you doing?
What are y'all up to over there?
I know. She just said that to the whole point. She didn't sit on purpose.
Neil's girlfriend just disappeared under the table, man.
What are you doing?
No, no one's mocking you.
Oh, goodness.
Love you, babe.
Bring me my e-cigarette, baby.
Question, do you do anything yourself, or do you just order your girlfriend?
Dude, Josh and Jessica, do you fuck my
girlfriend? I need some ice cream, babe. E-cig, babe.
Oh, God.
Babe, beer me. Go to the store.
She's back there. Even though she knows Neil's kid, she's telling him to fuck off. You gotta do it yourself.
I saw the bed. Straight up, fuck you.
Back in the kitchen.
Who do you think you are?
Thanks, babe.
I know. Thanks, babe.
Oh. Forgot the top part.
I'll be right back.
So, Neil, have you rode with... oh, fuck. All right. I was going to ask him if he rode with you, Joe, and Suburban Delinquent.
Who?
If Neil's ridden with you and Suburban...
No, we were trying to make it out there. It just kind of... It keeps getting kiboshed, you know. We're going to go, and then... You know, he smashes his teeth out, and then, you know, we're doing other things.
How far is it from Grand Rapids to Detroit?
It's like 2.5 hours, especially on a motorcycle. You could blast down 96, dude, and probably do it quicker than that.
Yeah.
It's not that bad.
That's such a trip, man, that I don't think about how big Texas is until somebody says they can basically go from one side of their state to the other in like 3 or 4 hours. It takes 15 hours to go from one side of Texas to the other.
Yeah. Yeah, Texas is an anomaly, as is Alaska. Yeah, I think you could fit quite a few of Texas in Alaska, actually.
Yeah, if you split Alaska in half, Texas would be the third largest state.
Yep. That's awesome.
My but it's a bunch of fucking wasteland, most of this.
Yeah. The government owns more than half the land there.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of it's tribes and shit, too, but there's a lot of fucking wasteland.
Yep.
There's some beautiful scenery, too. There's a lot of beautiful shit here, but yeah. Well, you get it for 2 cents an acre back in the day, I think, so that's a pretty good deal.
Nice.
That's what America bought it for, right?
Yeah, I think that's what it was. Something like that.
Hey, do any of you guys know anyone who's ridden the West Coast, like, say, Oregon to up into Alaska, up into the Panhandle? Do any of you guys know anyone that's done that before?
What about the view on
I'm sure I do. But...
Be a wet ride.
Yeah.
You can take the ferry into Haines, which wouldn't be too far. Because I've driven all the way up into Canada. You go up into, like, through Coke and stuff. And
yeah, through Vancouver.
Yeah, there's ferries you can take. It'd be way quicker and shit.
So. That guy has Bill and me.
Who has?
Bill M.A., the BWOM series. That shit was epic as shit. He drives to, I believe it was Alaska, back from... it wasn't exactly just from Oregon. He drove from, like, the Midwest.
Yeah, that's crazy, dude.
That would be awesome.
Check the... I put the link in the thing. If you just watch one of those, you'll be addicted. He has really sick videos. Him and his buddy did it on some KLRs.
Oh, that's cool. I'll check that out, yeah.
Yeah, that'd be sweet.
Hey, has anyone seen...
I want to get like an adventure sport and do that shit.
Hell yeah.
Has anyone seen Dom's Big Adventure? Little Dom's Big Adventure? No. Or heard of it? It's this dude who's riding from London to Japan on his little Honda Dual Sport, raising money for charity.
That's it.
He just makes these videos along the way, and he does them really well. He narrates them and stuff, and... God, he's only got like 150 subs, but he does these awesome videos. I can't believe more people don't watch them.
Really?
Website.
Yeah. You should post his link up.
I have several times, but it's called Little Dom's Big Adventures. So, I don't know. You guys should check it out. It's pretty cool. Or maybe, oh yeah, I guess I could not be lazy and post it.
I found it already.
Yeah. It's... I mean... It's nothing spectacular, but he goes, like, through Kazakhstan and shit. You know, it's crazy.
That's pretty crazy shit, for sure.
I'm trying to find it. I can't find it.
I just posted the link.
Yeah. Oh.
Bam. Bam. Derek.
Little dimes.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, he's doing aid for Japan for charity for orphans. Yeah, he's doing all that shit. Yeah.
Yeah, it's...
Man, I wish I had freaking ball of status money to do shit like that.
But the funny thing is he's fucking editing these and doing it along the way. It's fucking crazy.
I mean, he's doing them in, like, hotel rooms and shit.
Yeah, and camping and shit. Yeah, or wherever he can go, you know?
If money wasn't an issue, just having the bike of your choice and riding the fucking world would be, like, the probably most best thing you could do in your life.
Fuck yeah.
No doubt. That'd be the shit. That's why rich people do it.
Yeah, I could just take months off to ride across the country.
Yeah.
So you guys know that you can map stuff by mileage. You can draw lines on Google Earth and shit. You know that, right?
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
What? You can do that?
Yeah, you can. I do it for when I do shit on the big lakes. I do my mileage and everything, my path, my start point, my destination, how many miles it is, how many nautical miles it is, shit like that. But you can draw lines all over Google Earth, not Google Maps.
Yeah, I did that with a bunch of my favorite West Texas rides, man, just for fun.
Google Earth is just shit, though, because you can go all around and zoom in if I can go back.
And you can go back in time and satellite images. You know that, too, right?
Yep, it's awesome.
You can roll back to, like, there's images of Kalamazoo, Michigan from the 1950s. Like, some of the first satellite images of
Earth. Are you serious?
Yeah, that's creepy, serious.
Dude. And those are, too, you know they, like, dumb them down for, like, Google, too. But you know
they have a lot more.
You can, like, just straight up see people just, like, fucking doing whatever in their backyards and shit.
It's crazy that you think about every single license plate on there.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Yeah. That's a lot of stuff to put into, though.
So right now, I just figured it out. It's an 800-mile ride from where I would start in Oregon. I would start close to the Washington border. I'd go through Washington into Vancouver and then straight across all the way to the panhandle of Alaska, 800 miles.
Panhandle to where?
That's not that bad.
What's that, like 18 hours?
What's that?
What's that, like 18 hours?
I'm not sure. But, you know, I would go through Seattle, Vancouver, and then run. Actually, it's kind of hard to run north, isn't it? 97, 33.
Have to go through Canada, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, you have to go through Canada, through the mountains.
Yeah.
Oh, God, that'd be the shit.
Yeah, it'd be awesome. What, are you thinking about doing that?
I want to hit Alaska. I'm going to go riding in Hawaii in March, and then I want to hit Alaska, and then I can hit the rest of the 48 states. I want to ride in every single state before I die. So I'm going to make a plan out of it. Like,
are you just going to rent a bike? Or
Or other places. It depends. You know what I'm saying? We might even take a U-Haul, load the bikes up, take them to where we want to start. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then go from there. Who's doing the maps?
Tim's
on the maps.
These are a bunch of my rides where you see these blue flags.
Yeah.
And nice. And there's so few people take photographs out in West Texas that Google Maps and Google Earth and Panoramio, is that what it's called? They have a whole crap load of those pictures you'll find in this part of the country are pictures that I took.
Rattlesnake Bomber. Can you find my
bike? Bomber base?
Can you find my bike on there? it's on there. Where in the world is Ian's bike?
There's a lot of cars, a lot of my cars on there.
How many cars do you own?
Three. All Hondas.
Mm. Yeah,
I have a Honda.
Because it lasts forever. I got a Honda. Honda Pilot?
Hell yeah.
CRV.
I got two CRVs and one Civic.
I just bought my wife a CRV this spring,
All-wheel drive?
Oh, yeah. Loaded, yep. Limited, yep.
That's the shit. Yep, I had my wife in a all-wheel drive Mercury Mountaineer before I bought my first CRV.
Oh, yeah.
She was used to being able to take on the snow. Like, everybody else is getting stuck, and she's, like, fucking blasting through it.
Man, that's what I need, something like that.
And I found the CRV, and that pretty much did the same thing, dude. I got snowed in Cleveland a couple of winters ago. I had about 2.5 feet of snow, and that fucking CRV just backed right up like it wasn't even there. It was crazy.
This is Rattlesnake Bomber Base right here. In World War II, this was a heavy bomber training base, and the Enola Gay was here, which was the first first B-29 to drop atomic bombs onto Japan.
They were dropping them in New Mexico, right? Is that where they were launching them from?
Yeah, they would launch out of this base, and then they would practice over New Mexico at White Sands.
Yeah.
And then back here. And there's nothing left. This is just like a police driving training course. But you can still see what's left of those huge-ass runways out there. And then they've got this sign. We tried to go in one time in Panoramio, and Google already took the sign. But it's all leased by the state now, and you can't go in there anymore. If you guys have ever seen the movie Fandango with Kevin Costner, the Pecos parachute school scenes were all filmed out at Rattlesnake Bomber Base. It's a pretty cool place. Very eerie and ghostly.
Nice.
A lot of ghost towns in West Texas. Most of my rides are to old ghost town shit like this. But it's fun. Oh, crap. Why won't it turn off? You guys seeing me or the map?
Map.
You guys see?
I see the map.
Son of a bitch.
Map. You got to click the little in the top corner. You just click on the icon for the thingy-jig.
Fish Fine, that Mountaineer was as fun as shit in the snow, dude. It's got the Mustang, or it was a 99, I believe. It had the Mustang motor in it. And it was all-wheel drive, dude. We used to just fucking go out and get nuts. I'm actually surprised we never bounced it off a tree or a curb or something crazy. Some of those nights when the snow would just start going and it didn't stop, like, we'd go out and get nuts in that thing.
You guys have a good one. I got to dip out right now. You guys all have a good night.
All right.
Take it easy.
Cheer! Cheer!
I can't do cheer.
This doesn't work. I really like those cool ghost towns, but one is like 4.5 hours from me. That's a little too far.
No, dude, we got them everywhere.
You're lucky. I love ghost towns. What's going on over here? I like how Google Maps will tell you, like, if there's a hazard or something sitting in the freeway or whatever. That's pretty cool. I appreciate that.
I've been adding pictures to Google Earth for quite a few years now.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
How do you do that?
Neil, you probably have two.
Pictures of your Goody. Because I do those. I do the Google Map virtual tours or whatever.
Yeah, where you tag your pictures to locations on the map?
No, like I work for Google and publish like the actual tours of businesses where you walk around inside.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's how I got my bike on there, because I rode my bike to the thing and posted it and parked it right out front when I started it. So so when you go to that tour or whatever, you see my bike sitting right there.
What business is it?
It's I'll post the link in the chit chat. There you go. It's like an ice cream shop or something downtown.
Oh, that's funny.
Is that it?
Yeah, click that, and then it should start out, like, kind of looking right at it. You're on the street or the sidewalk, and then you can, like, walk inside the building or whatever, but...
So Google pays you to do this?
Oh, nice.
Yeah. So, well, actually, the business pays me directly. Google, they don't take any money for it, so I get to name my own prices, and they pay me direct, but I just publish it on Google for them. So, like, I have their API, and I... post it. I post the tours and like lay it over the satellite map, like right on top of the building, how it would be like inside the building.
And is that your web address in the top left?
The NJB photography, yeah. Yeah, that's
here's
my
Google. Here's another West Texas ghost town right here. This place is called Hyman, the unfortunately named Hyman.
Hyman,
Texas.
Hyman, Texas.
Yeah, that's my. I miss my ZX7R. I never should have sold that bike. Huge.
Where the fuck is Dan at?
Dan left because he had his gay lover over.
God damn it.
They had to get down to business.
God damn it.
Joshua.
God damn it.
God damn it.
Thank you so much for that, Carter.
What do you put on your rear tail light, Neil? Is that or does that come stock?
The integrated.
Yeah, one? That's nice.
I think it's I don't know. I think
I remember seeing something for like all the ninjas, like different ones, something like that.
Yeah.
Like
the integrated LED. I think it did have a big old like dildo fin on it, and then the guy I got it from had already taken it off, and then.
Mine came with a dildo fin too.
I made like my own custom like license plate bracket to like move it way up underneath, and I made my own custom LED like illuminator for my license plate that shines like an orange light.
That's pretty cool. And you can legally have those lights on your bike, can't you? Like the pimp lights.
I think so, because they're orange, so it's not like illegal.
Okay, because in my city or in California. Like, you can't have any lights, like, any underglow, anything.
Really? I don't know. I've never been pulled over yet, so there's that.
You know, Tim, that's a nice ZX7.
Yeah, I know. I'm sitting here crying looking at it. Can't believe I sold it.
I would have bought a ZX7 had I not gotten... If I wasn't into dirt bikes or anything, I would have gotten a ZX7 easily. If I could find one.
I had that bike for 11 years.
Damn.
When did Josh leave?
A couple months ago, I think.
He kind of dipped out.
Yeah.
Yeah. He said bye.
Oh, did he?
Yep.
Maybe I was making a drink or something. My damn cat.
You know, we have some ZX7s available, but, like, they're all wrecked and are now naked sport bikes because they couldn't find the fairings and all that other shit.
Well, kind of where I am on those is that, yeah, you're right. They're getting harder and harder to find parts for as far as body work and stuff goes.
Yeah.
Of course, mine was in pristine condition, but the main thing about it is, you know, that's a hard bike to ride. The reality of it, I mean, I romanticize it and I miss it and I miss the sound and feel of it, but really that bike was a torture rack to ride.
Really?
Very uncomfortable, yeah. For me it was. I mean, I'm 5'9", I weigh about 160-ish, 65 pounds.
We're at the same weight and height then.
With cattle? Yeah.
It just, it was just an uncomfortable bike. I mean, when I was 32, and when I bought it when I was 32, it was pretty comfortable, but at 43, it wasn't as comfortable, you know.
When did you sell it?
I sold it in April or May. April.
Okay, this is recent.
I sold it when I bought my Bonneville.
Okay.
Yeah. But it was a really good bike. I mean, it never gave me any trouble until ethanol fuel, and I was about to have to do a whole bunch of stuff to it, you know.
Ethanol's fucked everything up.
Because it didn't like ethanol, and I didn't want to mess with it, so.
Crickets.
What is Joe doing?
Yeah, what's going on over there?
What the fuck is that?
This is penis pump.
So, where is everyone from? I got West Texas. Where in West Texas?
Midland, Odessa.
Midland, Odessa.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a lot.
Midland, are you?
I didn't realize it.
Midland, Odessa. That's...
The oil patch, man.
I think my mom's friend lives there, actually, somewhere.
Okay. I probably know her.
Sounds really familiar. We got Michigan.
Hey, I was born in Pontiac.
Pontiac, Michigan.
Yep.
Where do you live now?
Now I live north of Pontiac in a small town called Ortonville.
Oh, so you're Michigan, too?
Yep, still in Michigan.
Okay.
Michigan, born and raised.
You ever lived anywhere else besides Michigan?
Have I lived anywhere else besides Michigan?
Yeah.
No, I don't think I have, actually. I mean, I've been all over the place, but Michigan's always been where I lived.
Okay.
Where are you at, Carson? Carzon?
Yeah, Carson. I am in Central California, so like, Modesto, Visalia. It's like all a big clump of cities.
Modesto, yeah.
All within 20 minutes of each other.
My family. A lot of my family live in California. Yeah.
Where are they? Where are they from?
I'm trying to remember. Well, I have family in San Diego, and then a bunch in LA. I'm trying to remember where my my grandma lives.
I have some family up in Alaska. I think they're responsible for a lot of the roads, road paving in Anchorage.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and so they. I don't know. I don't really know them at all. I don't even think I know their last name, quite honest with you. But they're like distant up there.
Sweet.
Yeah. I've never met him, but I hear about him a lot.
Yeah. You haven't, like, gotten in touch with him on Facebook or anything?
No, I don't even know who they are. I have family all over California, like in Salinas, L.A., Monterey, and then in Nevada, and I have some in Idaho, too. And so, like, once a year we all get together and hang out, and that's just my mom's side of the family. She has four brothers and sisters. So yeah,
big family.
It's a huge family.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah. You like living in California?
It's all right. You know, I live in a desert though, so it's like, it's not really exciting.
Are you near Palm Springs, or you're west of there, right, or something?
I am north of Palm Springs.
North? Okay.
Very north of Palm Springs. Yeah.
Oh, very north. Okay.
Yeah, I'm in how can I put this in comparison? Where Monterey is, Monterey's on the coast. So if you're heading east to the middle of California,
yeah,
like dead smack right from Monterey, you'll hit exactly where I am. It's just a desert. So, yeah.
I know that feeling. I live in the desert too. In fact, yeah. I was watching your latest moto vlog today, Cars on Cars, and I was thinking, or maybe it was the one before, I was thinking to myself, dude, that looks like West Texas. It's just a bunch of desert.
You guys get rain.
Oh no, we don't get rain.
Tim.
Oh. Yo.
That's what I was saying. The difference between West Texas and where Carson lives is that you get rain, Tim, and he doesn't.
Yeah, in fact, it rained. We had a pretty good rain today, and it rained last night. In fact, that's what jacked up the ride I was supposed to go on.
I got rain coming all week.
We got rain on fucking lockdown over here.
Yeah, we got rain on lockdown.
Dude, it's been raining. I don't even fucking know, dude.
On the freeway.
This has been an unusually wet year for us. We usually only get about 12 inches of rain a year, but we've had more this year. Yeah. Our rains always come in late summer and late spring. You know, like late summer, early fall, and late spring, early summer, and then it's dry the rest of the time. But we've had small amounts of consistent rain all the way through this whole summer. So it's been unusual.
It's been.
Is this Carson
over here?
Carson Cars, you got a DRZ?
Yeah, I got a 400 SM.
Oh, okay, nice. Cool. All right, I just subbed you guys.
Oh, thanks, man.
I'm trying to sub all you guys.
I need to sub you, but when we did that last hangout, I was going to sub you. And then I couldn't remember what your name was.
I know, I need to post links to everyone's in the thing. I always forget to go back.
And, you know, I don't tell people, like, what can I say? When people, I don't even know how to share videos. So like, when people share my videos, and I mean to share other people's videos. Like, I don't even know how to do that because Google Plus makes it so weird and intricate. And I'm not good with technology at all. So
all you should have to do to share a video on Google Plus is go to the YouTube side and make a comment and whatever, and then it'll tell you also share. It'll ask you also share on Google Like with a little checkbox, and then you just check it, and it'll put it on your Google Plus page.
Okay, yeah, that's pretty embarrassing. You know.
Oh, really? I didn't know that either.
Yeah.
When I first got into this, I was like, I really like doing this. But then when it came to editing, I was like, fuck, I have no idea how to be doing
this. Dude, I suck at editing.
Yeah, I'm so bad at it. You know, for the longest time, I'd blur out my license plate with a fucking a font that said ghetto license plate cover, and I'd have it cover the whole fucking screen because I had no idea how to blur things out or anything like that.
Oh, fuck.
You just got to have the right software. It's not that hard.
Once you I figured it out. What do you guys use? What do you guys use, actually?
I use Adobe Creative Suite 5.5. I've got the Master Collection with After Effects and Premiere Pro. And
Photoshop. Is that a monthly thing? Or
nope.
Premiere not Pro.
Not off. It. Yeah, not off Pirate Bay, it's not.
the new Premiere is a monthly thing.
I mean, no, bad. Yeah, we don't do that.
Yeah.
No, we don't do that stuff. We're totally legit. No,
well, I got the Premiere, the Adobe Premiere 12 or whatever it is. You know what that is.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know if they're doing it all on subscriptions or not, but mine actually, the one that I've got, I was in business partnership with an ad agency for several years, and we bought a bunch of licenses for it, so I mean, I have a legit license for mine. But now I don't know how they're doing it.
What do you?
Yeah, now they only do subscription based. You can't even buy a legit. You can't buy like a standalone copy for your computer with no internet connection.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah. So the last version you can get is CS6. Is it the last version you can have that doesn't require an internet connection?
Wow.
What do you use?
An internet connection?
I use CS6.
The version that I'm using, Adobe Premiere CC, right? That's the supposed to be the paid version, right?
Creative Commons.
Okay. Okay, now here's the deal. You can use that without paying for it monthly if you block their IP addresses from block the program from calling home.
Yeah, you can do that. I don't know. I just stuck with CS6 because I already had it installed and it works legitimately. Yeah,
for sure.
I'll keep using.
I didn't see any new features that were like must have to go through the extra trouble.
No.
The only thing that 5.5 doesn't have that I wish it had is the warp stabilization.
Warp stabilizer.
Yeah, so that I wouldn't have to, because you have to do it in After Effects and it's a pain in the ass. Yep,
and then you got
to
go back and forth and it's all kinds of extra time. But the warp stabilizer, it's pretty slow. Even if you have a fast computer with a fast graphics card to like assist it. It's still pretty freaking slow. Like if you had to do like a minute long clip, it would take quite a while. But it works good. It works really good.
What the fuck is that?
It just stabilizes your video if it's shaky.
Oh.
And it gives it an interesting look too.
Yeah, it'll make like a hand shot video look like Steadicam kind of.
Huh.
So now to get the Adobe Master Collection or whatever, you have to pay a monthly subscription to use it, or do you pay a one-time fee?
Nope. It's
subscription
monthly.
There's a monthly, but I bought the Adobe Premiere Elements. I'm trying to look
at it. Okay, yeah. Elements is kind of like a stripped-down version of...
Is that... I figured it is, because I fucking can't figure out shit on it.
Yeah, it's like a stripped-down version of Premiere, just like Photoshop Elements is like a stripped-down Photoshop, so it doesn't have all the good shit, really.
Oh, so I'd be better off paying for that subscription.
Yeah, because like I saw online just yesterday, you can get like Photoshop and Lightroom or something like that for $9 a month, which that's legitimate. I guess I would pay that. That's a good price. I don't know how much it would be for Premiere a month, but
fuck that. I want something better, man.
I think Chase said he pays like $50 for Premiere a
month. Dude, I'd pay $350 for Premiere. I would. Like, I don't have any problem paying for the software that I use. You know what I'm saying? Good software, good developers, you know?
Oh, yeah. Adobe's legit. All their stuff's
good. Yeah, exactly. I wouldn't have a problem paying
for that. So Elements is just the stripped-down version of all that crap, then.
Yes.
Any Element version is... Oh, right here. It says right here, single. If you want to choose just a single application from Adobe, it's $19 a month, $19.99.
That is so weird to me. What a weird business model.
Well, because they figured everybody's pirating it, so if we just make it a subscription base, people will be like, okay.
It didn't work.
Yeah. Instead of paying like $5,000 for Master Collection, we can just have people pay like a cheaper amount and always have the latest version up to date. So, that's yeah, so if you wanted Premiere Pro, it would be... I guess you can do a Premiere Pro for one entire year, and it's $239, which I guess that's worth it.
Yeah, totally.
Well, that's the same price of paying $19.99 a month.
Yeah, but you used to be able to buy Premiere by itself for like $5.99 and keep it forever. And now they want you to pay $250 a year. This is going to lead to even more pirating.
This is like my textbooks. You know, you can buy them online and have an ebook, which is basically a PDF that you can't print.
Yeah.
And then you have it for 6 months to a year, and then the company takes it back from you.
All right. It says right here you can do the complete entire Master Collection for $50 a month.
Whoa.
Which I guess that would be wise for a business, because if you're gonna buy a bunch of licenses to Master Collection, and the Master Collection's like $2,000, and plus your licenses for each seat, you could just pay $50 a month for each seat that's using it, and always have the latest version. And then when the new version comes out, you don't have to buy the upgrade. You know.
That makes sense.
Yeah. So I guess it's a better deal that way.
I've never liked the idea of pay as you go.
Yeah, when I buy something, I want it.
Exactly.
I always have it. I own it. I want discs or I want
DMG file or
whatever. Yeah.
If you're going to school, though, you get a student discount, student teacher discount up to 60% off.
Yep.
That's really good.
Ooh. I'll have to find someone.
And I need to go to school just to get the discount and then quit school and keep the discount.
Did you go to school after high school, Neil?
What's that?
Did you go to college after high school or no?
No. I just started working.
Yeah, neither did I. I graduated from high school, and I literally just dicked around and did music for like 10 years just on my own, like random places, girlfriends, apartments. You know, 20s shit.
That's what you're supposed to do in your 20s, man.
Exactly. I got real good at some things, you know what I mean? That's what kind of took me to the next level, was the things that I was doing was... I was just...
Uh-oh.
Oh, it all cut out. I think your mic died.
He's still talking.
I know,
he's riffing, man. Hey, Joe, your mic died on you, dude.
His headphones probably died, so he can't hear it. Oh, wait, there it is.
Oh, no, he's messing with us now.
Get it. We missed all your story.
I'm back. That sucks, man. Fuck this headset. Brandon, fuck this headset. No, what I was saying was like, yeah, as a musician, you just do shit for yourself. And, you know, most guys that stick with it, anything you do in life, if you stick with it, you're going to get good at it. You know
what
I mean?
That's exactly right. Yeah. That's kind of what I went through. I mean, I have to split my time. I mean, I'm on the road a lot, but I also have my own business to supplement my income.
Yep.
And it's all production based, audio production, video production, graphic design, and all that stuff. So that's it keeps awesome. Me real busy. But that's the main thing is that I studied in college. I studied applied science and I studied audio production. And I have basically what amount to associate's degrees in both of those. And it was supposed to be a double major thing, but I got tired of college, so I stopped. And plus, I wasn't going to go into debt. Like, when my scholarship money ran out, I wasn't going to run up a bunch of college debt. Screw that. I was ready to get out into the real world.
How do you get a scholarship? I've tried applying for scholarships all over the place, and I've yet to be able to get one. I'm middle class. I'm white. My mom graduated college. I cannot get any scholarships at all.
There were two scholarships that I got on. One was an academic scholarship, a private scholarship, because okay. I had good grades out of high school. And then the other one was this scholarship called the Abel Hanger Scholarship. It's for graduates of West Texas schools, and I think they still have it today, 20 years later. Basically, they pay for you to get an associate's degree at any of the West Texas colleges. So your associate degree, your first 2 years of college essentially are free. They're paid for. And nice. if your grades are good enough, that scholarship also buys all your books. And I think they still do it the same way. Anyway, that's how I got my education, but when the money ran out, I didn't have a lot of money and I wasn't going to go into debt or get student loans. So I just stopped. I started, you know, for a couple of years after that, I toured full time. And
that was smart, dude.
Yeah, I feel like it was. My life's turned out good. I've never had a hungry day or a broke day. I've been able to make art and music my whole life and make money off of it, so I'm certainly not complaining.
You know, that sounds just like our financial aid that everyone gets here. It's basically if you're living by yourself or you make under 20 grand or something a year, then they'll give you like 8 grand on top of paying for your schooling.
Right.
Oh, wow.
Nice. Yeah, it's ridiculous. And my friend got it. He bought a car, and then he took a lot of the money gambling. He used to gambling a lot.
Living on the edge, huh?
Do you have to pay that back?
No, that's all free money. This is
like federal aid for people that are in poverty.
I can't afford not to pay it back, though.
You better quote poverty, because my friend's not...
what they consider like the federal poverty level is like, I don't even know. It's like
it's like
14 grand a year or some shit.
Oh, ours in California, ours is like 40 grand.
Yeah, everything's ridiculously expensive.
It's 30 or 40 grand for anybody living in a family. But my mom's a single parent, and she doesn't make amazing money, but like she makes enough to support my brother and I. Mm-hmm. And so we still don't qualify for anything. And when I did qualify for something, I used my dad's tax return, and then they said, oh, you know, he got 50 grand out of nowhere, because they were looking at his tax return and everything. And I asked him, like, where the fuck did you get 50 grand? He's like, oh, you know, when your grandma died, she gave that to me. And so they took away the financial aid I got from to pay him for my classes, because I wanted to go apply for the grant with the tax return. And they took my financial aid away to pay for my classes only. And so my dad's like, oh, right, well, you're shit out of luck, and took all his money back. I'm like, what the fuck?
Wow.
Yeah, so I got fucked both ways on there. So that was the only time I've ever been applicable for financial aid.
Well, if you have a pulse, you can come out to West Texas right now and make about $35 an hour doing anything.
That's pretty amazing, too.
$35 an hour?
No, doing man. What? Like what?
Working in the oil field, driving a truck, working on an oil rig, working in support or supply for the oil industry. We have a huge labor shortage out here right now.
Yeah. Are you serious?
You can go offshore, too. You can hit the offshore rigs, too.
Yeah, yeah. If you want to go down on the coast and work on the offshore rigs, I tell you who's making the big money right now is underwater welders. They make like $200 or $300 an hour.
Oh, those
hell yeah!
Underwater weld that shit.
That shit's dangerous.
It is dangerous. That's why it pays $300 an hour.
Yeah, that's what I got.
Call me fucking Jacques Cousteau.
What are the dangers of underwater welding? Like just fucking drowning or what?
Shark beak?
All kinds of dangers.
Barracudas.
You have to be a diver first. You have to be an experienced diver. Then you have to be an experienced welder. Then on top of all of the underwater welding equipment is unique unto itself, and you got to be certified and all that.
Really?
Yeah, you can be electric.
And the driving equipment too. Yeah.
Yeah, and so anyway, but it's a lot of money, and but it's dangerous. I mean, you've got all the dangers associated with deep water diving, and all the dangers associated with being electrocuted, putting electrical stuff in the water. You know.
Oh yeah. Bug Nasty asked, "What got you guys started moto vlogging?"
Shade Tree Surgeon.
Suburban delinquent. Did it to me, but it was personal between me and him. He had just started doing it, and then I got a motorcycle. I've been hemming and hawing over getting a street bike forever, and when I finally did, he's like, you got a moto vlog. So at first I did it to just kind of entertain him, but then I started to have fun with it.
Mm-hmm. Now you're entertaining all of us.
Right, exactly.
Yeah, I was looking for someone who had the same pipes on their Bonneville as I had on mine, and I found Josh's video where he had put those exact same pipes on Jessica's Speedmaster, And that's how I discovered motovlogging. I kind of knew that people did it, but I didn't really know what it was. And then I went back through and looked at his, and I was like, I got to do this.
That's awesome,
this is a total waste of time. I'm in.
You know, when I was 17 years old, I went to the beach with my girlfriend at the time, and I saw everybody riding dirt bikes around the dunes in Pismo Beach, down south from where I live. And so after that, I'm like, I just want a motorcycle. Like, it looks cool. It's fun and cool, because my parents have always been against it, hated it. They did not like it at all. And so I would watch, if anybody remembers Blinky Cab, the Australian guy, I used to watch Blinky Cab a lot, to watch a lot of M13. And then started watching Jake, and that's why I got the DRZ, because it looks like he was having so much fun on that, you know? And nice. So...
That's why I'm about to buy a DR200, because Baker X Derek has so much fun on his.
Exactly. Yeah. It's so much fun.
That's how I know, because I got a SM2 DRZ400. And I bought it and was trying to learn more about it, and that's how I found Garden Snake, and then just started going from there. But I didn't know people did this shit.
I didn't really know either. I knew people were... like filming themselves riding bikes, but I didn't know there was like commentary, you know?
Yeah.
I had more experience in it with mountain bikes, because I've been a mountain biker for a long time. And
I've thought about doing that on my bicycles, because I've got a road bike and a mountain bike, and I've got camera mounts that'll work with my GoPro, and I thought about that. You could vlog doing that even easier than doing moto vlogging.
I thought about doing it this winter when I can't ride. I'll ride my bike to work and in the winter. And,
yeah,
that would be cool.
That's what I thought. Like, what are you doing? I'll probably just switch back.
Or some shit.
Well, I thought I said Budge Nasty. I'm sorry, Budge Nasty. Budge Nasty's Dirt Bike Channel.
What comments.
Guys, go ahead and subscribe. He's the one who asked that question. And what got me into motovlogging was over winter when I can't fucking ride here in Michigan, then I started watching, looking up vids and stuff, and actually it was Baker X Derek, and then I was like, oh, this looks fun as shit. I've always wanted to do it, but I never like wanted to pony up for a GoPro because I just have DSLRs and shit.
Yeah. So,
I finally, like, I was like, fuck this, time to get a GoPro. I, like, saved up some YouTube money and fucking got the GoPro and then started doing that, which is, it's fun, though. I like it.
It's great. You're good at it, too. Your shit's hilarious.
I try.
Oh, yeah, you're the shit, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You don't mind me asking, is the YouTube money pretty good? Or is it, it's eh?
I don't know. Like, before I got, like, the subscriber bump or whatever, I'll say I make, like, $100-$150 a month.
That's so, not bad. That pays some bills for me.
Yeah, it pays me enough to pay my bike insurance and ride, and then...
How often do they pay you?
Put some back into my channel. It's once a month. You only get paid once a month. And you
have a PayPal account or something?
What's that? Yeah, they pay you through your PayPal. And then it goes in. But if you're going through just YouTube, you can get it directly into your bank account. If you're going through a network, I'm in a network, so they pay me only through PayPal. So then I have to go PayPal to my bank account. And then if you're in a network, they take a percentage of what you make.
Yeah. It's like so
when I was on just Google AdSense, I made a lot more. But then, because when you sign up with a network, Google still takes a portion, and then the network takes a portion off of that. So you get, it's like Google takes their portion, then the network takes 25% of what's left, and then you get what's left over.
So when 150 is what you net, right?
Well, it's actually a lot more, but then Google takes some, and then the network takes some. So that so that's what's left.
That's what, like, you net, okay.
Yeah.
Well, I have not monetized mine yet. I'm going to have to do some things to my channel before I do, because I have this one video on my channel. It was this old motorcycle video I used to have from the late 80s, early 90s. And I thought, man, I'm going to go look and see if I can buy this online. And I couldn't find it anywhere online. And I thought, well, it must be out of print. It's 20-something years old. So I put it on my YouTube channel. Dude, it has like 100 and something thousand views.
is that the 90s motorcycle training?
Yeah, it's called Street Smarts.
I watched that the other day. I watched like 25 minutes of it before school.
Yeah, I got a crap load of
that shit.
Well, I can't though. I would have to pull that off if I decided to monetize my channel, which I'm.
Oh, because you don't own it.
I don't own it. But
no,
it's all right though, because
you just don't monetize that video. You
don't
down. You just don't put ads on it.
Oh, okay. So you only monetize the videos you want to.
Like when you go to publish it, there's an option like you can monetize it or not. So even if it won't let you, you can even go through and click an option and it will remove like the music or whatever that's blocking it. So then you can still monetize it and it will literally cut that music out of the video but keep like your talking and stuff.
Okay, gotcha.
Yeah, I don't monetize, but I've used a few people's songs in my videos. Like, but the only one they ever had an issue with was this Bjork song I used. And all it says though is that I acknowledge third party content. So
that just means that if you monetize it, they'll send the money to them. Is what it means.
Yeah, and I don't.
Sometimes it'll let you do a split. Like they get a portion of that particular video.
Because I did one moto vlog where I used, it started to rain, and so I used Here Comes the Rain Again by the Eurythmics. I have a couple of third-party content notices, you know, throughout my videos. But, yeah, most of the time I use my own music.
I just switch. Well, when you get in the network, too, like I'm with Full Screen, and they give you access to audiomicro.com. So anything from there you can use, and it's considered free because it's part of your network or whatever. So sound effects and music. And you can usually find something decent on there.
That's where you get your music for your videos and everything?
Some of it. A lot of it. I've been using like some of Big Guy's lyrics because he said I could. And then I got some friends who make like beats and shit. So a lot of that has been there. Because it's not copyrighted. I know. Make me some beats. Freaking.
If you guys ever want to, you can use any of my. I can't release the Creed Fisher music to you. But you guys are welcome to use the Tim Kreitz music. Just give me credit for it, obviously.
Yeah.
But I'll put. I'll put a link to it.
Tim, there's a local band called Whipsaws. I use them in one of my videos, where I go to Crow Creek Mine. Anyways, you might like them. They're actually kind of nationwide. They're Americana style, not quite Southern rock, but.
Okay, yeah. I'm always interested. Independent artists are my favorite ones.
I listen to
very little of anything from the mainstream. I listen to tons of Texas music simply because I'm a Texas artist, and when I chart a song in Texas, I want to be following what the other artists are doing too, because we have Texas, we have our own music, our own charts, our own everything, our own music system and radio network and all that. But I always listen to independent artists, man. It just seems to me like 90% of the time, that's where the best stuff is happening is with independent artists.
Yep. Well, nowadays, yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll check them out.
Although I do like some bigger kind of, you know, people who are on major labels too, but yeah.
Well, I do too. I mean, I still love Led Zeppelin and you know, I mean, the list goes on. Eric Clapton.
Well, I listen to. But new music out. There's not much new music that I listen to on the radio.
Right.
Not saying that it isn't on a major label, but or even smaller labels are kind of major now.
Most of the radio shit sucks.
Oh, it fucking sucks big time, dude.
Oh, dude.
Yeah, music is trash today, man.
Dude.
I mean, not all of it. It's just now you got this huge puddle of crap there. You got to weed through to get good music. You know what I mean?
Well, you just can't go to the radio or MTV or something for your music. You gotta actually.
Dude, MTV doesn't even have music anymore.
Yeah, I mean,
nothing but reality.
I tried to stop myself, but it just kept going.
It's nothing but Rob Dyrdek shows is the only thing that are on MTV anymore.
Rob Dyrdek's all right. Like he seems like a pretty cool person. He does interesting things, like things that nobody else has done. But then it's like when that's all that's on, it gets old.
I'm with you. I like Rob Dyrdek, but I would still like, you know, I can remember when I was a little kid and MTV came out, our favorite thing was, man, to have a have all your friends over for a sleepover on Saturday night and make popcorn and stuff and watch whatever the Saturday Night Live concert on MTV was.
Do they still have, like, MTV 2? Do they actually play music videos on that? I don't know. Like, 90% of my life, I never had cable.
I don't have cable anymore.
I still don't have good cable, so I don't get, like, any real anything. So I don't know.
I tried to shut cable off, and they wouldn't let me. They insisted that with my internet connection, I must have basic cable.
How was that? So not having cable being like a hipster. My girlfriend just called me a hipster because I said I never had cable. Sorry. No, not too cool. Too poor. I only get cable for.
There's fucking nothing on it, dude.
Yeah, see, there's nothing on it. I don't even know how to work the TV. Ask my girlfriend. I'm like, babe, I don't know how to fucking work this remote. Like, put a show on.
If there's something we want, we stream it online.
That if there's something I want, it. I just bootleg it.
Yeah.
It's like, Game of Thrones? Oh, I'll download it immediately when the episode's done in HD.
Go to Project Free TV, we get a lot of shit off there. You can just stream.
I watch all my cops there.
Yeah, there.
I get everything off IP torrents. It's the best ever.
You just download it?
Yeah. I just download it straight to my computer, and then that way I don't have to worry about like lagging or anything like that. And you usually get the HD.
Yeah.
All right, there's my links right there, my Reverb Nation page. I think I got like 20 songs on there.
Ooh.
If anybody wants to find me on Facebook, I put my regular link to my regular website.
Hey, Echo Boy, what's your? It's Echo Boy Michigan. Is that? Do you do your moto vlogs?
You know what? My Google fucking thing is weird, dude. It's like I have two separate accounts for some weird reason. I don't know why. But what do you want? You want the link to my videos?
Yeah, I just don't. I haven't. I don't think I've subbed you. I got everyone else, but
that's it. You're out of these live streams. Fired.
No, that's what I'm.
Just kidding.
I was trying to get everyone. That's the whole thing. I couldn't find him. I looked up Echo Boy Michigan, and I couldn't.
No, it doesn't. My shit's hard to find for some reason. It's stupid.
Well, post a link.
Yours is hard to find too, Rob, because I tried to find yours after the last live stream and I couldn't find it.
Oh, I know. Really? I'm sorry, guys. I didn't post up the ones from the last one yet.
Here's the link to my videos.
I gotta get on that shit.
It's all good.
Yeah. Echo Boy 2.
Okay.
And then post the link to your video page too, Rob, and I'll sub you right effing now.
Sub, guys.
Sup, guys!
All right, yeah, okay. You gotta give me an audio file of you doing that so we can
I need to stop doing that, apparently.
No, we love that, man. We love it.
Sup, guys!
Sup, guys!
All right, go ahead. Everybody... Yes, everyone is mocking me right now. Thanks.
No, we love it, man.
Everybody go ahead and post their channel links in the chat comments, the group chat, and then I'll put them in the video right
now.
Links. I just got I already got you, Echo Boy, you're good.
Okay, I gotcha. There you go.
Yeah, wait, you gotta I need to sub to you too. I've been making my rounds with all you guys. Making my rounds, watching videos here and there.
Babe, can you make me a whiskey?
You know, I was looking at it. I'm following like 55 or 60 moto vloggers now.
Wow.
How many? Livin' Rob, you need to go into your YouTube settings and change it so you can change the name of your channel to a specific name. Because right now, it just says, like, channel a fucking bunch of gobbledygook.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so you can change it to, like, /user Echo Boy or /user Baker X Derek instead of /channel fucking crazy.
User numbers.
Yeah, crazy, for real? Where do I do that at?
Crazy numbers.
Gangsta.
I don't know. Dude, it's Google, so it's like a crazy fucking shit fest.
I had to look up a video on how to check my messages. Like,
it's so fucked up.
It's horrible.
You would think it would be like so streamlined and like easy, but they're like, let's make this as complicated as Google Plus.
It really is. And you know what else? When you subscribe to somebody on YouTube, like I'm subscribing to Rod right now, I just did it. Okay. So now, okay, big freaking deal. I'm not following them on Google Plus. They tie all of this stuff together, but now I have to go over to Google Plus. I have to click on his Google Plus page, and then I have to go follow him over there after subscribing.
It's a fuck fest.
It's stupid.
Yeah.
And then if I want to like invite you guys to like video chat, if I don't have you in a Google Plus friends group, then I can't just like type your name out and have it show up and like click your name and send an invite. You must be in a friends group to be able to send you like an invite. Otherwise, I have to like go to Facebook or.
That's why I don't get your invites on Google Plus because my actual Google Plus isn't part of your circle.
Yeah. No, I added you. I think
you added. You added the other Echo Boy. You added my Google Plus page.
Oh my God. It's so weird though. So then you have to like log into Google, click your own name to your Google Plus, then click Hangouts. And then maybe it'll show.
No, I already know what it is. That's why I just told you to send me the link earlier because I already knew.
Neil, whenever you say you invite me, I never get the invite for whatever reason. I'm part of your circle. You're part of my circle.
Yeah, you gotta go log into YouTube, click your own name to your page, then click your own Google Plus. And then look at your own Google Plus, and then go to the top left corner and click the drop down. Then click Hangouts.
That's when you're on your Google Plus main page. Now you can have other pages attached to that Google Plus main page. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
So it's got to be the right one because I've got a bunch of different Google Pluses, and it's all fucked. I got one for like just me, my regular, and then I got one for like my photography thing, which is a separate Gmail, and then one for the my YouTube, which is like all fucked up when I made Kyle Classic, so it's like some weird.
I saw that website.
Yeah, it's some weird.
So funny.
It's some weird address, and it like linked to that somehow, and I don't know how to get it back, and it's all stupid. Fuck.
Google makes no sense, man.
Yeah, they're like so huge. You think they could get their shit together to where it'd be like so easy?
And they had the actual navigation of the YouTube area really nice. I mean, I didn't have any complaints about it. Oh, and then they decide to add that stupid-ass Creator Studio out of the blue.
Oh my God.
That doesn't make any sense.
I did a rage video about that. Cause
I saw that.
all the time, they're like, oh, hey, let's just fucking throw a huge wrench into what was good. Like,
yeah, it doesn't improve it at all. It just makes it different. It makes no improvement.
It's more clicks just to get to what you need to do.
Oh my gosh, man.
They just like bury it under more shit. They probably just sit back in their office and laugh.
Yeah, because they know there's not an alternative. They can do whatever they want. They're just fucking with us.
Yeah.
All right. I'm going to go get one more beer. I'll be right back.
All right.
I got to finish editing this fucking vlog or it's never gonna happen.
Do a live edit. We'll give you pointers.
I would do something like that, but the stream is so choppy. It's not, you guys, you know what I mean? You're seeing like frame. me and Sub D were doing it the other night and it was enough to like I got the general idea of what his video looked like. And so obviously the audio is fine. The audio stream's fine. It's the video that's like chop, chop, chop. Kind of sucks. Okay,
whoa, what's all this, babe?
Whoa, babe. Where's that whiskey sour? With a cherry.
Holy shit. Whiskey fucking city over here. that's my girl. She's like, hey, let's take some Wild Turkey 101 proof and then add some barrel aged fucking they take the bourbon and then they age it in beer barrels that had bourbon in it even longer. So it's just.
That's a lot of bees.
Yeah, I gotta. Yeah. That's all kinds of bourbon and all kinds of aging, and I gotta get up for work tomorrow.
That's a barrel bourbon. Bubble.
This is what you gotta get right here, Neil. I don't know if you've ever had this. This is Ska Brewing. They make this cream stout right here.
Ska Brewing, I like it.
Yeah, man. It is really good. This is the first beer I've had all night that's not a homebrew.
That looks good.
Delicious cream stout. Black as hate, sweet as love.
I had a milk stout this past weekend at a local brewery. They used the Andes mints, the chocolate Andes mints?
Uh-huh.
That, and they made a milk stout, and it was pretty fucking good.
That sounds awesome. Damn it. Well, I knew it would happen before the night was over. My fucking video plugins failed again.
What?
Why does it keep doing this? It just tells me now. So I'm looking at the video screen, but it either shows, if somebody's live on camera, it just shows plugin failure, and I can't see what you're doing. And the only people I can see are the people who are just using, you know.
Icons? Like you can't see what I'm doing?
I can't see what you're doing. I just see your backwards E, but I'm sure what you're doing is completely offensive at this point. And
it's not, bro. I swear to God.
All right, well, hold on. I got to restart my browser, so I'll be back in like 30 seconds. All right.
Does anyone live in Vermont or close? No, nobody does on this, do they?
No.
Montpelier.
Does anyone watching this right now live in Vermont or close to it? I have a super request, and I will
hook you up somehow. We got a lot of guys in Toronto, and they're a lot closer to Vermont than we are.
I want a beer called Heady Topper. Heady Topper. And you can only get it in Vermont because they don't distribute. But apparently, it's one of the best IPAs like ever. It's got like 100% rating on Beer Advocate. Heady Topper. Wow. Someone give me Heady Topper. it comes in a can too. Like what? Is it? But it does.
Some of the best beer actually comes in cans.
Really? Well. Steel Reserve, Mickey's, Colt 45. That's what you guys should have handed out in Detroit. That would have been like the ultimate classic.
Handed out Colt 45s.
Billy approved.
Some fucking King Cobra.
Yeah, King Cobra. I mean, because let's face it, I'm not being racist at all, but every person you threw a beer to was black.
They were fighting for it too, man.
I'm not. That one dude took all three beers, jammed them in his pocket, and was just like, fuck
him, guys. He did. He took all those beers, dude.
I take that beer.
I like how he's like, hey, give him the two other people right there, and he just fucking jams them.
He did. He's jamming them in his fucking pants. All right, you guys, I'm gonna go edit.
All right,
I'm probably gonna head out too. I'm gonna go eat dinner.
If you guys are powwowing later on into the night,
I gotta go too. I gotta get up work early.
Exactly. Everybody's got things to do. I gotta get up at 6 in the morning tomorrow too. So.
Ooh.
Ugh.
All fun stuff.
Oh, you get to sleep the day away.
All right, I'll see you guys later.
Later.
All right, take it easy, guys. Have a nice night.
You too.
All right, man.
Bye.
All right, so we'll be live for a couple more minutes before it shuts off recording. Is that you saying goodbye? Is that what that's supposed to be?
I don't know what the fuck that is. You got some pale ale there. Oh, no, you're drinking an IPA.
That's a stout, man.
That's an IPA.
That's that cream stout I was telling you about. I just poured it. This is the first beer I've had tonight that it's not a homebrew.
Oh, no. I was talking. I can't see you, Tim. You're blank. All I can see is your sticker. But
damn it. What the hell?
Living Rob.
Rob, damn it, Rob. Oh, yeah. I was trying to say it. I see your IPA. Then I got a glass of Sweet Tea. I don't know if you see that.
Nice.
Down South Classic.
Hell yeah.
That's crazy. Are you seeing me, Rob, or are you just seeing my avatar?
I see you now, Tim. You're back.
Oh, right on. Here.
I've been seeing you. Yeah, you've been there.
Okay. Just must have been a momentary thing.
That's why I lifted my beer, because I saw you lift yours.
Oh, yeah. Cheers, brother.
Sharon. Cheers.
Frankie.
Hey, man, I'm digging that music, man. That Creed guy, he's a good singer, too.
Yeah, he's a good singer, good songwriter. He's a good guy. We've been supporting him on tour and in the studio. In fact, I produced his second record, and I'm hoping we'll have our first number one hit in Texas off of that record. So big ass crossing of the fingers. We got into the top 40 with a couple of songs off of the last album, but it would really, really be good for us to go all the way to the top in Texas, because if we do, that's kind of the gateway to the more national charts. So I'm just literally keeping my fingers crossed. In my early 40s, early to mid 40s, man, something's going to happen. It needs to happen now. You know, I don't want to be playing bars for the rest of my life, but we'll see.
Yeah.
Either way, it's a blessed life, so I don't mean to complain.
Sure.
But I would really like to have something significant happen.
Right.
Know?
Oh, I get it.
So.
I get it. You work that long, that hard, doing something, you know.
Yeah,
you want it
like
to pay off in the end.
And it's mainly so you have the means to do really good things for other people. If this last 20 years of working my ass off doing this would just have, even if I could have a moderate payoff where I could do things like I'll tell you what would be really nice to do is, okay, I'm a Freemason in Texas, and our Grand Lodge wants to have all of this work done to their old building at the Grand Lodge, and they're trying to raise money for that. It would feel so good to be able to just take a huge chunk of cash and give it to them and just donate it and just say, man, this is for you guys to do this work with. That's the kind of stuff I dream about when I dream about hitting it big. But
that's
if
cool.
If I don't, I'll still find other cool ways to be good to people. But
for
yeah,
sure.
Yeah.
We'll see. We'll see how
all it goes. Right. I'm going to try to get this video up tonight, so I'm gone. Gentlemen,
I'm looking forward to seeing it.
Oh,
yeah, it's been
dude,
a pleasure.
Dude, this one's fun.
It's going to be – I've already watched Sub D, so I can't wait to see your version of it. It's going to be
this
awesome.
This one's fun.
are you going to get it up tonight?
I'm going to try, dude. I'm really going to try. It's like I'm close right now.
Okay. Well, I get mornings is when I watch my vlogs or my videos, so I'll watch it in the morning then when I go.
Nice,
away.
Man. Cool. Nice. Yeah, I'll start going. I sub to your channel too, Rob. I'll start going through your videos.
That's
yeah.
Cool.
I just subbed you too, Rob, and I'm gonna. In fact, that as soon as we're done here, I'm gonna bookmark your video channel and I'm gonna start looking through your videos too. So.
Right on.
It's all good. So I guess we'll just call it, man. This will be the first time we've quit before the recording quit. So.
Yeah. Tim, it's always a pleasure.
You bet, man. I'm so glad I found you guys. This has become very important to me. So I'm looking forward to seeing you guys next week and seeing videos in between. You guys, man, be safe and God bless and all that.
Yeah, you too.
All right, man. Good night, guys.
Later.
Later.